ladies and gentlemen. Is this working? I hope it's working. Please let me know if my microphone's working, if the music's working, if you are working. I don't know. Yeah. So, wait a minute. Before we get here, meantime, how's everyone doing today? Ahoy! Hello, hello! I do realize that I kinda messed up and only posted the announcement right now. I was meant to post it 15 minutes ago, but I kind of miscommunicated with myself. I got my mic a bit louder. Okay. How's this? Is this better? Hello? Hello? What does this do? It's not my mic, I don't know. How's this? Hello, 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 hello. Hello. Music's a bit loud, yeah, I just turned it down. Welcome all. Welcome, welcome. So I believe Alec and some others should be joining us soon. But for now, so I don't know if we've posted much about this in our previews on our various social medias, which you can find links to in the description. We have a brand new Instagram among them, but I don't know if we've posted about this on our Reddit or our Discord. Hello. But as of late this summer, I and a few other people have been working on, this thing called the Battle Tile Map. Which, imagine taking all of the different battle maps and stitching them together into one great big, almost world map of battles. So, that's why I'm here in Inram, in Attila. So we can come into here and I can show you guys some of it before we work on it. So we are going to be working on Edoras, Anelond, and perhaps Umbar. But I currently need to get the files for it from someone, so if I don't, I'll end up getting, we'll end up probably doing Tarnost. But anyway, so as you guys can probably see here, no more Europe on this map, but rather Middle Earth. You can click in various areas. I believe I've showcased some of this. Look, now we're over here, in whatever this place is called. Now, we're over here by the White Mountains. Now, we're over here by Campbell? I think. Now, we're over here at Dale. Now, we're wherever. What we can also do, Portisol. Now, we're over here. The city of Long Gallen. So actually, hold on, I just realized that I forgot to initialize the ship submod. So here we go, so I can showcase what this does. So as you can see, you've got that sort of places you can more intuitively click, find a battle, almost sort of procedurally generated. So if we come back in here, okay, Port Assault, Long Gallen, beautiful city, by the way. All right, chat, what do you think? Should we be attacking or defending? I'll wait a minute so that you guys can give me an answer. Should we be attacking with our ships or defending? And so you can also see really anywhere you want to click. And it is the Middle Earth map. Very similar to, I'm sure most of you are familiar with how it works in the base game. We can click up here to the Dead Marshes, or here to the Wold. I don't think I have any Isengard things. Over here on the Anduin, actually. defending. Okay. Lund Gallen. And do know these ships are from a submod. We're just currently using them for testing purposes. What is this? This is Imphalus, so we should have Imphalus coast levels. So that's how that works, I think. Those guys can be on the coast. These guys can be on the walls. These guys can be at the coast. Those guys can go there to meet. These guys can be at the gates. You guys be in the cities. You guys be on the walls. Don't want to make this too much, actually. Probably show more ships. Sorry. Okay, and for the sake of this, we're going to have Mordor attacking here, since they have some ships. There we go. Oh, oops. Save army setup. What did I just name this? See, I don't know who else does this, but I just do random things for names. Yep, there we go. Start the battle! As you can see, we've got our coastal deployment zones for our ships. There are a few bugs with this, because I messed up some things when I was exporting it for this. So there's a bit of whack. Sorry, on me. Alec made a lovely map. It's one of my favorites.
It probably is my favorite currently in the mod. Admittedly. Oh! You're here!
Did you notice us snuck in here?
No, I didn't. I didn't notice.
I did in your middle of monologuing, so I didn't interrupt.
Huh. Yeah. So this is a map by him. This is actually our first AI map. He pretty much self-taught himself how to do the naval AI, because none of us really know. Sorry, I can't do full screen, because this is on my big monitor, and Attila doesn't like going to 2440 by whatever. It doesn't like going extra large, just like your standard 1980 or whatever. But yeah. As we load in here. Oh, we did a dev clash on here when we first got it ready, and I'm very proud to say I, with I think 5 Gondor ships, smashed both Mehron and, I smashed Alec and Jox at sea, and then saved Zarn's butt. So, yeah, if you need a naval commander, just ask me. Did anyone else sneak in there, or is it just you, Al?
Oh, it's just me.
Okay. Can you guys hear him okay?
Yeah, can y'all let me know? Does my mic sound fine?
I can hear you. I don't know if they can hear you. I hope they can hear you.
I'm pulled up, so... Yeah.
What sound? This must be one of Mehron's new ones. I'm jamming to it. So here we are. We have the forces of Mordor coming in to attack us. We must be ready. Okay, so we got our ship boys here. since none of the ships in this submod have ramming, we can just, you know, just show them our flanks. We'll let them board. I should have brought more archers. Archers is the name of the game. That's what we found out with our testing. You wanna join the VC, Maron? You gonna come in? Say hi? Or are you just gonna leave us alone? Abandon us because you don't like us.
Thank you all for letting us know.
Yeah, oh yes, thank you. So as you can see, I love how this... I don't know if I've specifically told you this part that I love it, but I love how all this is. Well, Oh, is it? I'm not good with them. You know, we have coast levies. The coast levies should definitely be on the coast. Like, I'm just gonna put these guys here. It makes sense, doesn't it?
I like
it. Yeah, so I'm also just taking a minute to have a bit of fun with everyone. And show them all. Yeah, these... You did a battle on here with us, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you were defending, I remember. Yeah, I decided... We had completely lost. It was Zarn and I attacked... No, who was attacking? I don't remember. But we'd completely gotten smacked around. Whoever... I think Hagnaz and I were attacking or something. So I just took, like, one ship, all that was left of my fleet, and just landed it over here and just walked up and just, like, stabbed... Some of Mehran's guys in the back. It was quite fun.
I wasn't playing that first one.
No, that was the second one, I think.
That was, yeah.
Where I did that.
You're playing Pixmice. But yeah, we're planning on doing this sort of port assault live.
Oh, we are? Oh, I don't want to spoil it then. Should I not spoil it? Or I'm just trying to showcase them what this is. I've been completely distracted with showing you guys this. I haven't showed you guys the real thing. You'll notice there's no water border here. There's no flat plains or anything. This map is on the campaign, sort of. We've got the nice open bay going out there. If I bring up a concept real quick, you can actually see where this is in the tile map.
Ignore that kind of big patch of...
Yeah, ignore this. These are some bugs, things that stuff we worked out. But yeah, no water borders, no nothing. This is smack dab on it. So you can see how it all just melds together. I can show you guys this later, if you guys want to. So actually, if I load up this tile map.psd, that's the wrong tile map. Oops. File. Open. Terrain. Battles. Attila map. Tile map.png.
Hello, thank you.
So right here, we've got Long Gallen, and we've got the coast. You guys can see it there as it sort of bends around, comes up to there, bends around, comes up to there. As it goes here and here, we've got all of our nice rolling hills around. It's a nice little valley coming down to there, but yeah, this is what it looks like.
Anyway,
so if we were to do a battle and click a bit to the left or the right, we could do a battle out there, a land battle, completely separate from this city, and you can have the city in the background, and I absolutely love that. It's one of my favorite things with Total War in general. I just love it. Anyway, I'm gonna make sure I set this.
Orford Saxon saying that we're already further in development than 1212, medieval kingdom 1212.
Well, they have their camp.
They've got the campaign, and that's the... Yeah, they don't have to have a custom map. But we've got things more advanced than them, yeah, like battle maps. It's not quite comparable at the moment.
No.
And Gabrielle, cheers from Brazil.
Cheers.
Hello.
Okay, but this seems good. I think I placed all the units. Who knows? So yep, here we go. We've got our naval battle, our coastal battle. We've got these Umbar Corsairs coming in. They're gonna try and break through here, our little line of ships trying to defend. Sure, I'll show you guys that in a minute. I just want to showcase some of the port assault things. Oh, flaming arrows going out. And while this is all happening over here on this front, the Umbar ships are making a beeline for the coast. I'm going to try and stop them from landing, actually. I don't know if this is going to work or if I'm going to just end up exposing these landing points. Or those flame arrows might just sink my ships before they get close. But I've got a bit of a defense here at the landing docks. While they fire down over here. I personally love port assaults, just because it's like you've got the two battles going on to the city at once. One from the sea, one from here. Oh, yep, they're making a beeline for the coast. Head them off. Head them off! Go! No! Don't let them land! Forward! I don't know. That's my best.
I love filling in the voice lines.
Yeah. So as you guys can see, I'm not going to play through all of this. I just wanted to showcase some of what this is. I believe there will be some custom siege engines eventually. I'm not going to play through this whole battle. Sorry to disappoint anyone who wanted to see it. I just wanted to showcase a bit of the port assault. But yes, so we do have port assaults now, or coming soon.
See the full thing. We will do a proper battle stream of that.
Yes. But I know someone said they wanted to see sort of the battle outside the city. And I also saw someone mention battle with the city lights in the background. Alec, do you know if this city has, if Long Gallen like has lights so that if it's at nighttime you can see it in the distance?
That city doesn't, no.
Oh, does Lynn here?
No. Okay. The only thing that has something like that would be Minas Morgul. Like okay. Lights?
Well, I mean, not necessarily like big lights, but where you could see it in the distance like during at night or something.
Do
we have anything that has
think
that?
So. The only... No, like, I haven't put any point lights on any of those maps.
Okay.
I guess in, like, a realistic sense, you would see, like, torches and stuff at night.
Yeah, but I'm wondering, do you have any of that stuff on it?
No, I haven't done any stuff like that.
If we load into a battle here... So, as you guys can see, I'm no longer... I did not select Long Gallen. I've just selected this... Syracuse, I guess. We're around Syracuse, if anyone wants that for scale or something. So this is outside the city. And then, if I look over here, you guys can see it's Long Gallen. It's in the distance, off over there. Hi.
It's amazing. Can't wait to see Minas Tirith from Osgiliath.
So actually, we were doing a bit of testing. You can see Minas Tirith and Minas Morgul from Osgiliath. You can't see Minas Morgul from Minas Tirith or vice versa, but you can see both from the middle, which is quite fun. But yeah, so you could do this nice big battle out here in outside of the city. So this would be a sally out or something, or if you just end up doing a siege relief, one of those types of things. I am noticing some texture glitches, there with the terrain. I might have to do something about that. So you could also do a battle out at sea in this bay. So all of these things surrounding a settlement that could or will happen. Anyway, so that's what I wanted to show you guys of this right now. So now to work. Did we get any word on the Umbar?
I
don't think we have any word on the Umbar situation. Okay.
Not my map.
Well,
so
he's
know.
Saying we probably don't have it.
Right now. Oh. Wait, is Anolond a port assault? I guess we'll find out. Because if it's a port assault, I'll need your help on how to do the AI there, since I don't know. Mehran, do you want to answer some of the questions while I get this up? It seems we have a few questions
in
chat.
Yeah, sure. I can see Dimka saying that we're going to have custom siege weapons. And we've already got a custom siege weapon in game, which is Gondor's trebuchet.
Oh yes, we do.
So yes, there is more planned. You know, the dwarven ballista, Isengard ballista, and the Dalian wind lance. I think it's cool. Plenty of cool stuff. Troll catapults. And okay. Matt Haley asking, is the Gondor fiefdom rework being modelled by anyone yet? And yes, as Fingus is saying, one of the models has been receiving some love, but the rest are undecided at the moment.
Is that really cool concept idea public yet? Because I love that. Just like the idea of that one. The one with like the black and gold or whatever.
No, I don't think it is actually.
Right, because I love that. I don't, not even like the concept of it, but just the idea of it.
It's just, I'm looking forward to doing that one, yeah.
All right, so yeah, we have Anelon. Well. Awesome. And where's Anelon? Wait, is Anelon? Hey. Oh, I thought Anelon was a Gondor settlement.
Yeah, it should be.
Oh, it's right there. Okay, Anelon. Okay, so this is a port one, I think, with a river. So I might need some help from you, Al.
Okay.
And then, of course, we've got Edoras. Wow, where's that one? Oh, it must be somewhere over here. Who knows where Edoras is? I don't. Yes, so that's what we actually have prepared for today, is we've got Anelond and Edoras. We're going to be putting them on the map, and so we can mess around with them. We were going to do Umbar, hence the thumbnail, but it seems we may have lost the files for it. Don't panic about that, though. That's temporary.
Yeah, I can change it to a thing of the Golden Hall. That's nice and clickbaity as well.
Hmm?
The Golden Hall of Edoras.
Hmm. Oh, yeah, if you want to do that, that might be best. Or wait, does that mess up the live chat replay? I can't remember what does it.
Shales? Oh, I'll change it after. I'll change it after.
So actually, speaking of that, so yes, ships can sail up to Caryandros. Tharbad. There, and I think we were talking up to Grassy? Ships can sail up to there. Yes, so ships can sail up the rivers and places. All right. Can you guys see this okay? I hope so. Wait. Oh, is this the wrong version? This is
You're probably lacking,
Oh, yes. Sorry. I know what's wrong.
Oh yeah, the Eastlings are getting a special siege weapon too. Yeah, thanks.
Oh really? That's cool.
Yeah, I don't have developer buildings on.
The last casualty asking, kind of unrelated, but how many factions will make up Hrad and Rûn? If I remember correctly, it was said that in the past they wouldn't be one faction each. Yes, so three factions make up Hrad, and around five or six make up Rûn.
Yep.
And they'll both be, you know, both be around uniting the tribes.
Here we go. We have it on the concept right here.
There you go.
So we've got, Mehrond can actually probably say more about these. So we've got one, two, three, four, five, six. I don't know.
Yeah, so six. You've got those two yellow ones and the golden one. And then you've got Khan down the bottom.
Oh, yes, we've got Khan.
And then if you look at...
And this is the one
and
you
the
play.
And the red one
right?
is the one you'll play. Yeah.
And then
there's two up north and then two to the west. Of the red one.
This is I don't know if we previewed this, but this is our current start positions map. If you guys want to
we've previewed this one.
Alright. Yeah.
And then if you look at Harad, of course the red one is the main serpent tribe.
Yes.
And then you've got Umbar on the coast and you've got Far Harad.
Best boys. I just like them. Just because it's cool and they're gonna have jungle maps. That's what I'm excited for.
Yeah, that sounds cool. I want to do some jungle maps.
Yeah, definitely. I really want us to... I really hope we can do something special with one of, like, the jungle cities and, like, make it, like... I'm, like, picturing, like, some sort of, like, Ewok city or something.
Yeah, we can go like crazy with them. There's nothing. Yeah.
Why not?
In the film, so you know.
I don't know if we, if in anything really with Total War, there's like a proper like jungle city. I don't know if anyone's ever done that.
Yeah. Travis Williams is very much looking forward to the Blue Wizard Rebellion mechanic for the Easterlings.
That one, that's, I think, I helped pitch that one a while ago, or an early version of that.
But as far as I know, that's not going to be in the first release, just because it's, I don't know the reason behind it, but that won't be in the first release.
Full analog? Wait, is there supposed to be a wall right here?
Yeah, it's meant to be a curved wall there, I think.
Oh, I don't have the curved wall pack. Hold on.
Everyone else saying.
Actually, Alec, do you want to just show me what to do for naval landings, or do you want me to, or do you just want to do them yourself and then just send me the thing?
I'll just show you what to do. It's only two things you gotta do.
All right. Well, I've got to get the
Adrian's saying that he's just tuning in, and sorry if this has been asked before, but what does the campaign map is upon us really mean? That's the title.
We didn't
the
clickbait. Title be,
I think the title may be a little bit too clickbaity.
Yeah, who did that? I think LG did that. Someone scold him.
Silly LG. No, we can change that afterwards, I think.
Man.
Because, yeah, I did sort of get the impression of that's like saying the campaign's finished.
Do you remember where, where in the SVN the developer buildings is?
Ooh.
Yeah, it's under like retail data or data retail.
Hold on, so data retail?
Yeah.
This don't freak out about this troll thing. This is just that sub mod that we released.
The SVN still absolutely baffles me.
Jux is Miracle Man.
Yeah.
That's all I know.
It's more just sort of finding where things are, because there's so many sort of paths.
I just try and stick to my section of it, because, and because also that's what I've been told to do, because I don't want to mess everything up. I'm scared I'm going to, like, somehow bungle all of it.
William asking, or Vinny, why don't you have all the packs active? Does that cause conflicts? Yes, so with developer packs, you know, you might get a pack just for a chariot or just for, you know, a map. And if you put them all together, it's just all, it'll crash your game.
Yeah, so pretty much poor Wizlet and Maestro. We just throw all of our various incompatible packs at them, and they have to stitch it together somehow.
Yeah, exactly. Ignar asking, will there be a stack of 20 Ents in ambush mode in Fangorn? At the moment, Ents aren't planned. It'll be another thing that requires animation with minimal reward. But you never know, we might in future.
Alright, well, I guess while this waits, we could start on Edoras. So, I saw someone asking what we're doing today. So what we are doing is we are adding Edoras and Anelond to the battle tile map, which I showcased a bit earlier, which pretty much means in the campaign selection, or in the custom battle selection, you can just go, click, and pick, and everything's all together. It's a big stitched-together battle map. It's a world map, almost, of battles that you can pick from anywhere. continental. Or Mediterranean. I don't know, I've just learned that you just gotta click a bunch and then just go back to default. And that this is what works. Yep. Works like a charm. So with Edoras, we bring it up on the map. Come up, PNG. Edoras. Is the music too loud, guys? Oh, no, never mind. I just had it loud for myself. I realized it was a bit loud for me, but then, never mind. Edoras, right? On that river? Where?
If you look at that PSD file I sent recently, it's got the concept lined up perfectly.
Yeah, I'm just looking with the battle tile map right now.
Jim Carr asking, I hope Mordor and Isengard have different recruitment mechanics. I guess so, yeah. Mordor is going to be very much more, you know, spammy than Isengard. Isengard's going to be quite different from an orc faction, I guess. And also asking, are we looking for more people to work on the mod? Absolutely.
Always and forever.
And if you go onto our Discord, there's a recruitment channel there.
Wait,
and you can read all the jobs.
Oh, is this river supposed to be linked up to that river? We don't have Chief Lord. Is this supposed to be the river that's on the map there? Yes, I'm gonna guess. Okay. Or is this just a separate river? Or what am I? Oh no, because this is how he. Okay. That's not gonna be fun.
Do we have the raw data for that one though?
Yeah. Well, this is the raw data right here.
Oh, right.
Oh, music's way too loud? Okay.
And yep, as Casual said, join the Discord for previews, community, and more. Yes. Announcements, competitions, tournaments. It's all there.
Is this supposed to be on the north or the south side of the river? I'm confused. This is confusing me. North or south?
I'm not sure, to be honest.
Lornor, any of you guys there, do you guys know, is Edoras on the north or the south side of whatever this river is?
It should be on the concept. Hang on, let me have a look.
It's on the north here, but I'm wondering with how it is here. Or with how it is in the map itself. I'm just trying to figure out how I need to hook it up. Well, that's awesome that you managed to catch it. Okay. Yay.
I mean, I guess the concept's the one to follow, so north.
Oh, I don't want to redo. I don't want to take it upon myself to redo parts of Edoras.
Oh, you're going to have to do that now, of course.
Oh, for God. Okay. What? Alright, let me first figure out what tiles this is on, at least.
Oh, Hagenaz saying that we can't hear you.
I turned off my music pretty much.
Tim asking how many nerds are working on the game's lore.
we've got one. Well, we've got a few. Is that the
Maestro
second
is
tile
our go-to
there?
Guy,
I'm trying to. tell.
Yeah, Maestro is our go-to guy for lore.
Alright, I'm gonna try tile properties.
And Ivan asking, how do we donate? Private message me if there are any legal obstacles in place for answering this question. We're not accepting any donations at all, just because that's putting us in a dodgy position.
Yeah.
Because of course this is intellectual property we're dealing with, so they could easily shut us down like that. So we're just not going there.
Yep.
And of course money, it can create conflict in a team.
Mm-hmm.
How do you decide who gets what share?
Yeah.
We're not recording our hours or anything.
South of the river, okay.
We recorded our hours, Haganaz would get all the money.
Yeah. And Frusty.
Yeah, if it is ours, Haganaz if it's ours, actually Jox just gets the whole pot. That's what I think. Jox gets the whole pot.
But it strikes me as really strange that things like Battle for Middle Earth Reforged are accepting donations.
Yeah. Ooh, you guys see what Alter posted? It's looking nice.
Go look.
In units.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, that's beautiful.
I know.
That's awesome.
Hello, map? Map. Oh, map cheese. Okay. Oh. Oh, darn it. Okay, that's not going to be fun. Okay.
Oak Lord. Love the mod, guys. Great work. Good thing it's not a Games Workshop property, eh? Yes, absolutely.
So if any of you guys have questions as to what I'm doing, what is going on, ask them. I'll do my best to answer them. So what I'm doing right now is I am currently setting up the tile linkages for the rivers. So as you see here, we have on this the different rivers and whatnot. I'm actually going to extend that one out there. And you can see over here with Lynn here. Don't mind it's pumpkin-colored matching fields. But I have to set it up so that it properly flows into the rivers, the coast, roads, etc. And so that's what I'm doing right now with Edoras, is I'm having to figure out how it lines up on the river, what's going on with that, etc., etc.
Right, I'm going to run off to dinner, but I might join you later.
Enjoy your dinner, Mayron.
Still going.
All right, see you later.
See ya, folks.
Zoom. Oh, there we go. Zoom. And what I'm doing is, so the reason I'm reloading this tile is so every time I make a change to the linkages there in tile properties, I have to reload it for them to take effect, simply because of how it loads outfield tiles in the editor. Well, it seems that I matched up the locations, right? Okay, now I just gotta sort this out. You're the map maker. Alec, what like height should I use here?
What are you doing?
I'm trying to, well, one, flatten this, and two, move this river so that it's going to be hooked up to...
probably use like 11 on an absolute brush.
Right.
Flatten that.
Yeah.
Absolute on their operation.
Yeah, I got.
Okay.
Yep, that seems to work enough. Okay. Now I have to delete these beautiful rocks. I'm so sorry. Oh, beautiful rocks. How to manipulate spline. Ooh, no. How to manipulate spline. I've got to move this spline so that it hooks up over
here.
Are
you asking me?
Yeah, how to manipulate spline. Please help.
I think you just have to redo it, fortunately. I don't think you can extend it.
So there's no way to extend splines?
Not that I know of.
You're the map man, so that's why I'm asking you.
I don't think there is. You just have to delete it and replace it.
So I have to go step by step along this entire river to replace this? And then I'll have to do it again over here, or whatever.
Pretty sure. I'm on a map right now. Let me see if I can figure out how to extend a spline. No, you can't extend it. What the hell?
Because I also don't want to make too many changes.
Yeah, you can extend it. If you've deleted something, just Control Z, go back.
No, I haven't. So how do I extend it?
Grab like the point at the end that you want to extend it. Have it on select.
Yeah, I've got it right here.
And will it just drag out?
Oh, so I can change it, but it's still going to mess with the flow a bit. Or...
Dude, I swear, I just tried this a second ago, now it's working. That's weird. Yeah, grab, like, the little box at the end, and you should be able to drag it out.
Well, yeah, I can drag it, but can I add more points, or... Alright, well, this works.
I don't think you can add more points, no.
I can do this. If I can edit the campaign, I can do this.
I believe.
I just messed it up. God damn it. Oh, yay, it works! Woo! I'm now a map maker. You guys can all leave. I got this. not you, Chad. Alec, we don't need you anymore. I can do it now. Haha!
All right. I'll retire.
No, I love your maps. No. he makes my his maps are my favorite in the mod. For whatever reason. I don't know. I just like his.
Thank you.
You're welcome. If the edges of this don't look good, it's I'm sorry. If the edges of Edoras forever look horrible, don't look there. I don't know. I'm not a map maker. I'm not good at this. Please forgive me.
I like the edges of the map will always look horrible.
Yeah, since most of our maps weren't made with it in mind.
Even, like, trying to take it into account, I still just don't fully understand how to make it where the edges won't be bad.
Nor do I. Oh, come on. Okay, there we go. That looks like it links up. Kind of. Sort of. I'm just gonna roll with it. This is the TED editor for Total War Attila. You can get it in the assembly kit on Steam. Okay, so if that's on that side, then that's gonna be up there at the top. How many tiles is that? So for those of you who don't know, who are just joining, don't know what I'm doing. Right now, what I'm working on is setting up river links so that I can set Edoras here on the tile map so that it's integrated into this river, along this river. Five? No, four or five. I'll try five. Is this a vanilla? No. This is Edoras. This is the Edoras map. For ROM, made by Lil What. No. That's wait. So, should I curve it? Yeah. Well, he has this nice road here. I don't want to mess it up, but... Goodbye, Rocky Rocks. I'm so sorry that I have to do this to you. Oh, yeah. Oh, no, wait, no, damn it. I really need to actually go over with you guys how to do these, because this is... I don't know what I'm doing here, I'm winging it. You guys know what you're doing. Alec here, who's with us, for anyone just joining, he's not talking right now, but he's here in the call with me. Is one of our map makers. So I'm echoing my complaints about this map, about like this stuff, onto him, or whatever I'm pinning it on him. You know, I half want to ask you how to make a bridge, but I'm not, because that seems
really easy.
Hard.
like really easy.
Well, at the same time, though, I don't want to make too many changes to Lolot's map, even if it is to do true. This. Are these changes? Oh, no, it's because he has a road spline there. Right? This isn't doing anything. Well. Can you edit road splines with brushes?
Yeah. Yeah, you can.
Why isn't it doing anything then? Hello?
What are you...
Oh, wait, hold on. My thing's messed up. Oh yeah, because I accidentally popped something out that I wasn't supposed to. Oh, why is it working now? But not over here. Hello? What? Why you no work? Oh, because that's... I'm gonna slap him the next time I see him.
What'd he do?
I don't know, it's just however he set up these rivers.
Yeah, rivers are a big pain.
You know what, now someone's gonna actually have to come in here when you guys like put on those buildings or whatever, like the Golden Hall. So I'll let that be fixed up then. This is just for now so that everything can be configured. If it's changed up a bit so that it fits better, that's okay. I don't want to bore you guys in chat too much. All right, so now that we have this. So, tile properties. So, we're on the south side of the river, and it goes, loops around. Okay. Down here. This looks like it's on the north side of the river. I'm gonna go with this concept. I know someone in chat said it's on the south. The lore book says it's on the south, but I'm gonna go with the concept. Random color, go. So now I get my 2x2 pixel brush. What? Two, four. I'm doing is adding this onto here. And I'm going to link in the rivers, because of how we just did them. Yay, it lines up. Finally, something works. Woohoo! I think I want to go three up. Wait, hold on. Sorry, guys, just trying to figure this out real quick. We got 69 viewers. Wait, no, that's not as good as before. No! We got 69 viewers! Okay. So now that we've got this right here, we can just bring this down. Alright, what does concept say? Concept says a river goes through this mountain. You feeling okay, concept? That is for another time, because that's for Dunhera. And I'm not going to work on that right now. I'm just here for this.
Someone asked, is this a vanilla layout? No, this is Edoras. I don't know if you already... I don't think you answered that.
Modded battle maps or modded campaign maps?
Modded maps limited to the size of the original one. No one really mods a map that was worked on by someone else, except for in this case, because it's just being put on the campaign. So the modded maps are created from scratch, but they all have to be made on an 8x8 tile. Yeah.
Unless you're talking about the campaign map, in which case that's different. Large settlement. Hold on, I need to ask if... Edoras 15-meter walls. Edoras 15-meter walls. Okay. Energy. Alright, now that I'm done doing that, because that I didn't sign up for that, you could say. Is Edoras 15-meter walls? I'm going to assume it is?
No, it's not.
Oh, Edoras isn't 15-meter walls.
No, nope. Nope, they got the barbarian walls, which aren't 15 meters. God, I was
nice save. I spelled your human wrong, but I don't care. Lol. What? It is. I think you will actually be able to see the Dunharrow from Edoras. You might be able to. I'm not sure.
That'd be cool.
There's a fair few settlements that you can see from other settlements. Well, I'm guessing you're... Shucks Kelly, I'm guessing you're referring to the campaign when the campaign's out. Because we do have a version out that is purely just battles, campaign, custom battles, multiplayer battles. We don't have a campaign yet. There is actually a submod for an older version that lets you play a campaign on the Europe map if you're up for, if that's something that interests you. But yeah, while the campaign isn't out yet, the multiplayer is, you could say, I think, yeah. Okay, so right now it's processing through this, and while that does that, I'm going to check the SVN. Is that all downloaded? Yes. Oh, I don't want to actually mess with that while it's doing its something there. Then I can upgrade that, and then we'll go over to Anilond, get that on. Then we have a bit of processing stuff to do. Then there's going to actually be a bit of trial and error with this, because there's a few things that you have to do with the coordinates to get things sort of fitted onto the map properly, or so that when you select them as a battle, you're fully getting that proper battlefield and not just a corner of it or something. So there might be a bit of trial and error that we have with that. Anyway, any questions? I am more than happy to take questions. The more questions, the more I can talk about stuff, the more I can interest you guys, keep you guys engaged. No? Any questions? Comments? Concerns? What did I have for lunch? I haven't had lunch yet. I probably should have. What did I have for breakfast? I don't know what I had for breakfast. Yeah, I had like a taco, some breakfast tacos. Now I'm just talking to myself. While this loads, any questions anyone has? How is the development of Minas Tirith, Helm's Deep going? They are still in the architecture stages. They're going well, but they are still in architecture.
But Minas Tirith had something that happened recently that is definitely a good sign.
I can completely understand that. Whenever I when I'm just doing custom battles, even I try and string them together into some sort of like story or something. That's the reason why those two are going pretty well right now, but currently most of our efforts are focused on Moria. Yes, most of our efforts for that kind of stuff.
Have been for a long time.
Have been for a long time. He knows that, because he's the one who's making Moria. He was doing a stream of one of the gates the other day. So yeah.
Yeah, it's nearing completion though. It's doing pretty well. But definitely, I would say most of the work is behind us.
So Alexander, we are going to have story progression. There are going to be a variety of scripts and whatnot, to sort of keep the AI on track and to keep, because this it's a Lord of the Rings mod. We are following the story of the War of the Ring, so. All of that, whether it be the treachery of Isengard, runic civil war, the Haradrim's power struggle, what Tom is eating for breakfast today in his little old cabin in the Shire. All of those so, so dearly important story beats and concepts are all going to be in it. And what I'm doing right now is just while this does its thing. Oh, it has done its thing. Okay. So if I exit out of this. File, exit. Just okay. Yes. What Pascal is saying. Oh, right. Should look at working data. That's retail. Train. File. Battle. Okay, there we go. Address. What color will it be? Red 99. I'm just going to move it down to here so I can do it at once. So that's easier. Red, 99. Green, 253. Blue, 66. That's a bit brown. I don't know. I think this color's a bit fitting for Edoras. You'll see it in a moment. What's neon green? That's the color Edoras is designated as. Woohoo! So I didn't just choose that. That's one of the things that's sort of more as it generates, does things. So yeah, neon green Edoras is on the map. Right there. We'll get back to Edoras shortly. Right now, if I pop on over to the SVN. I'm coming into here. Data. Retail. Data. Developer. Buildings. Pack. Move to data. Replace file at destination. Data. Data. Oh, let me check to make sure it's properly set up. I believe you will be able to restore cities. Actually, have we talked about that, if you're able to restore ruined cities? Like, yeah. I know we've talked about, like, Osgiliath, but, like, what about...
Yeah, there's definitely a plan for the most, like famous ones, at least. Like, that's one of the things I look forward the most, is to getting to do that. So, like...
Or is it just that whenever you capture one of those cities or whatever, the map itself is just normal? It's just, oh, it was abandoned at the start of the game or whatever.
I think that would be a city-by-city cases. I know there definitely will be multiple versions of each map, mm-hmm. but as far as how, is a question for Maestro.
Mm-hmm. And if you are, and if you have more questions about this, want to see more updates as things happen, make sure to join our Discord, link in the description, our Reddit, and also there. And I believe we've actually started an Instagram recently to post some artwork from various projects related to or around the mod. That should also be linked in the description, I think. Ted's loading. Will there be historical battles like quest battles? I believe so. We currently have one work in progress, maybe, as a submod. I'm not sure. I think there is a plan for them, potentially. Don't quote me on that. Actually, I'm fairly sure you can.
I got some plans on them. Yeah, they're possible.
Yes, they are then.
Unfortunately, most of the work, I think, is actually done in scripts and not the map. But yeah I definitely want to do those too. We just are so close to having a bunch of good options, but just nothing yet. But I think there is one being worked on. I don't know how it went there for the script.
I don't think he finished it, because he decided to, like, do something else. Like, make a fun, like, yeah. Wizards one or something. I think I was seeing he was talking about it. Alright, so now we have Edoras. It's Anelon time. Which is going to be a port of salt, right? Anelon's a port of salt. Okay, so you'll have to show me. Okay. How does this work? How? So it seems that we've got two landing areas set up here.
Okay.
Or maybe three. Do you want me to do? Do you want to show me how to do this first, or do you want me to set up? Or do you want me to set up the linkages first?
What's the linkages?
Well, like the different. Actually, never mind. Show me. Let's see. How do I do this?
All right, it's pretty simple. Wait, do you know where you're supposed to put it?
Why is? What? Hold on. Or is it just that there's no deployment zone on this side, so they can
No, that doesn't make sense. That's not aesthetically pleasing.
Is there supposed to be a curved wall right there?
I think so, but I did just get the latest thing, right?
Well, have you successfully seen them yet? You could have made a mistake on that.
Create... where would I look for it? Show building selector.
Gondor, and then... should be like fort wall, and then curved wall. Gondor forts, and then there should be another folder that says curved wall.
Joiner? No.
No, you don't have it.
So is it not in the current... because I just got the new one from the SVN.
One moment. Make sure I have it.
I asked Jox if he can pop in here to help.
Okay, did you get rid of your old developer buildings?
I pasted it over it.
Do you have any other packs that have to do with buildings, like the Moria ones or anything?
Not in movie mode, I don't think.
Can you change it to release?
Does it need to be in release? I thought it had to be in movie.
Victimize always says it needs to be in movie, but then, like, for me, it only, like, I just always keep them in release. That's what I've had the most, like, success with. But I'm not.
Hold on, I'm gonna be back in a moment. Hold on, guys, I'm gonna be back in a moment. There's something I need to go do. Yep, there is a bit of There is a bit of a defensive weakness there. So you said try it as release pack? Well, let me actually just see if they're in the developer buildings pack that I have here.
Yeah, try that.
Gondor fort wall curved, right? Fort wall curved, yeah. With stairs.
Yeah. Yeah, that's them.
Did he use, like, an older version of the curved walls, maybe, since I think Jox updated it?
It should have replaced. I'm not too sure.
It is a very nice city to blow up. Many cities are nice to blow up. Oh, sorry.
Alex Altair, you asked about naval battles, if you're still here. He showed off a naval battle at the beginning of the stream, if you want to get check that out. Lon Galen is going to be our first naval assault.
What?
And it's already semi-working, like, pretty well.
Export the rigid models to working data.
Oh, yeah, I always forget about that. Do you know how to do that?
Yeah.
Do you have the in-game assets?
No.
Okay, am I gonna need the rigid models are in those, yeah.
Well, no, I have the rigid models here.
Oh, you do?
Yeah. That's what's in the developer buildings pack.
Do you have Gondor curved walls, or is it to say curved walls?
Fort Wall Curved.
What's it called?
Fort Wall Curved.
Yeah, that's the Isengard walls.
Oh, that's the Isengard walls?
A lot of pain. Yeah, I've been through that. I was convinced that was the new walls. Those are Isengard.
So then where are they?
They're the in-game assets pack that takes forever to download off the SVN.
No, I have it already. I downloaded all of the packs on accident.
Okay, yeah. It should be called in-game assets.
Extract. Why is it called in-game assets if I need it for Ted?
Yeah.
Who did that naming? I'm gonna slap him. Who did it? Who done it? Sorry guys, this is the pain every one of us goes through with everything, trying to work like long distance, working on all of this stuff. You can see our pain and feel it too. Where'd it go? I thought I just brought it over here. In-game assets pack. Who had the bright idea of naming it that? Richard Models. This one only. Oh, there we go. Balin stuff. Okay, so this one should also be a movie pack? It is now a movie pack, because that's the only way I know to get things to work for,
Did you extract it into your working data?
I'm doing that right now.
Because then I don't think it, after that, it shouldn't matter for Ted.
I'm just gonna keep it like that, just because. Why is everything capitalized? It's not supposed to be capitalized. Yeah, it's fun. All right, I'm extracting the stuff. All right, we should be back in business. All right, so this goes right here. Analog, that comes in there. That's OBS. Not what I wanted to select. 888 files extracted. Woohoo! I laugh at my own joke. I'm funny. Uh-oh, the video might not be whatever. Can make a copyright claim. I forgot that we have. No, because I had the other music playing over it, so it wouldn't have recognized it. So I'm gonna turn back up the music, because I think it saved us from a copyright thing. You know, so you might think that I don't get what they're doing with the launcher. That confuses me.
Are you asking me this?
Huh?
Are you asking me?
Yeah, no, like that stuff, that stuff perplexes me. I'm like, that's scary.
I don't understand it. I haven't really looked into it though, so I think it might just be like once you have it downloaded, then update it in the future will be easier.
Boat tile. Assembly kit. Analog. Battlefield. Yay! It worked! Woohoo! Okay. So, we're back in business, everyone. So, how do these work? How do I do this? Oh, great. Sensei. How do I do these boat landings?
Alright. So, let's see. First, it's only two AI things, so you want to go to... I'm doing that right now. Okay. Alright, so go to create, and then object type AI hint polygons.
AI hint polygons.
Get a hint type beach landing.
How do I do that? Oh, hint type. Hint type... beach landing. What's beach landing fort approach?
Yeah, I just saw that too. I didn't use that on mine. CA didn't use it, but
that sounds. That might be what Jox was talking about with like fort wall docking.
Yeah, maybe. We can check that out in the future.
Yeah. For naval walls.
Okay, so you place it down, and there's gonna be like a triangle. Make wherever the triangle is, you want it facing out towards the ocean, and that's where a ship's actually gonna land.
Yeah, how do I stop it? Backspace.
Right click.
Oh,
I stop it.
Oh, do I do them individually or does it like auto generate?
If you want multiple ships landing at one spot, then you can do it in like a chain. But if you just want one ship,
how do I
then
chain it? Because each of these looks like it can fit three.
Like
ships.
left click, and it should be like you can spread it out some because each triangle is gonna be a boat landing. So maybe you do like three triangles there.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Three on each, that looks good to me.
Make sure, get rid of that one. You gotta go the other way. Start from right to left.
What in the world? Okay. Alright, so what's next? And also, I'm seeing wonkiness here with, like, these. Is that something bad going on down here that I should try and fix? Or...
No, I don't think so.
Okay. Well, you can't see under the water anyway, so... You can't see this. Oh, wait, did he do river splines, or did he do this as...
That's ocean.
Oh, no.
Not river.
Wait. Will this work?
I did ocean on Lon Galen.
Oh, you did? Well,
yeah.
No, I mean, but with the river here, is that going to bug that? We'll see what happens.
I guess we'll just have to find out.
All right, so what do I do?
We're all learning.
I've got those beach landing things. What do I do next?
Okay. Let me find my notes. I guess we can go ahead and do the gear region. I'm gonna have to remember how to do them. Actually, wait, let me just open Lon Galen. That'll be the best way. Yeah, so do you know how to do a go zone? It's in create and go zones.
What next?
Okay. Did you get the go zone down?
I have go zones selected. I don't know what go zones are or how they work.
Okay. So you lay it down just like a box, and it just means units can walk there.
Where do I lay it down?
So you want to you want to do the ocean, like where the where units can't walk. Like if you zoom out, can you? Okay, and near the shore, does it look like the height's like pink under the ocean? Can you see it?
Yeah.
So, okay, when it's pink, that means, like, units can walk there, but they'll be standing in the water. So, start the go zone, like, almost... You can start it pretty far back, like, in the street. You basically just want to outline the whole beach area. So, like, yeah, cover that, and then go down into the water past the part where units can walk. It's, like, where the boats will be. But you can go a little bit further out. Like, 10 meters or something.
Is this good?
I mean, there's no harm in, like, overshooting it. So go, like, double that from... Yeah, like, do like that. Make a box like that around both of the landing zones. So this will assure that the units won't have any terrain issues.
Yay.
Okay, now...
This is Anolon. I think it's new. Is it?
It's either a remake of an old Anolon. I think it is. Yeah, I think there's an old one. All the Gondor cities have... I think they've already all been remade. But none of them have been released yet. But it's gonna be nice. They all look great. So yeah, do the go zones around
the... They all look great. Made two of them himself.
Well, I made two of them, and then...
I know, but I'm saying you're patting yourself on the back.
Well, Lil What made, like, five or six of them, and they all look great.
Alright, so what's next?
I've
got the go zones down.
Okay, so what you did there is enough for beach landings itself. So you can do those outside the city.
There's no point... Oh, yeah, no, there is actually a point for it right here.
Yeah. That's all you need to just land, and then the other thing you have to do is for, like, AI to connect into the city. So, do the beach landing and the go zones on that beach outside the
how,
city.
How large should I do it here?
Along the whole coast.
Oh, along the whole... I thought you should only do it in, like, certain sections, or else it sort of gets buggy.
Well, like, don't do it where there's, like, cliffs, but that
I should do it for this whole section right here?
Yeah. Yeah, it should be fine.
Is that what you did for Long Gallon?
Yeah. I did five spots out on the beach there.
Well, so...
Maybe you gotta go... You gotta have the arrow.
Should I chain it together?
Yeah. You can spread them out, make the chains pretty big if you don't want it to be a bunch of little ones.
Does this work, or are they, like, too far out or something?
No, that should be fun.
Is this one too far out? Oh, that one's too far out.
It should be good. I mean, we'll have to see. We've only tried this once, so... I'm not even too sure on how it all works, but...
Alright, I've got
those. Do the go zone over that.
They're a bit wonky, but I've got them. Okay, I have that.
Okay, are you able to look at Discord?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna send you a screenshot of my setup, and then I'll try and explain it so you can see what I've done.
Oh, for the ship spawning?
This is just for the AI part, so, like, when the AI land ships, that they'll actually, like, go somewhere. It's not a lot more. So, let me know when you have that picture up.
I have it.
Okay, so go to CGI... CGI and then Siege node type, do entry node. And hint type should be node creation.
Yep.
And you got that?
Yeah.
Alright, so make that yellow box like I did where it kind of goes into the beach landing.
Oh, wait, what? Entry node. Huh? How do I still have... Oh, there we go.
Yeah, if you start dragging on the ground, is it a yellow box?
I'm not getting anything when I'm dragging on the ground.
Do you have create selected, or do you have select? Go back to create.
No, I have a frozen Ted.
Oh. Uh-oh.
What does this mean?
What did you do?
I don't know what I did. Help.
Ooh. I can't really... The stream quality is really low for me, so I'm having a tough time knowing what you're doing.
Don't crash. I just did Control Z. Oh. I'm just going to save it. Please
don't
hurt
me. That's... If that menu that's popping up is saying stuff that's incomplete when you save it, but that's probably for the best. If you visually can't see anything changed, then it was probably AI you did incorrectly, so it's gone now and you're good.
Okay.
So go back to the create tab.
I can't. The Ted window.
Oh, is it
frozen.
Still frozen?
Yeah, like Ted itself. I'm just gonna reload this.
Okay.
So you guys are getting to see me bumble through this because I don't know how to do this. I do the campaign. I don't make maps.
Welcome back.
Oh, hello, Maron.
What's been going on?
I've been struggling with map making, trying to figure out how to do naval AI, and trying to figure out how to fix the rivers of Edoras. Oh no, now I loaded the wrong map. Now I loaded Dale. God. Okay, here we are. Is my mouse dead? No. My mouse isn't dead, it's just... Hello?
Yeah?
Is working, so I can use my mouse and stuff, but my mouse is not working inside of the Ted window. It's working on, like, Ted's toolbar up here. I can see my mouse moving, I can use my mouse elsewhere, but inside the Ted window, my mouse isn't working. What? Why? That doesn't make sense. I'm just gonna reboot Ted. Have you ever had that happen?
What happened?
Leo, you screwed it up.
How did I screw it up? What did I do?
When you canceled the saving after the hints didn't work, you kind of fucked up Ted.
Oh.
It happened to me before.
Alright.
I bet you see some pain in Ted.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm gonna have to teach you guys how to do all of this so that I don't have to. This isn't fun.
Yeah, well, you can skip me, but sure.
Okay, now Ted doesn't want to exit. Oh yeah, because it's not, my mouse isn't working, so I can't select exit. Okay.
You just go to Task Manager.
I just X'd out of it. That works.
Thank you, Nev Nasi.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, thank you.
And Proxy War asking, any idea when the campaign map will be released?
Tomorrow.
No question.
Tomorrow? Did you say tomorrow?
Yeah, I said tomorrow.
Whoa. Tomorrow. Mm-hmm. We're going to release it tomorrow.
What have you unleashed?
It's going to be released tomorrow.
In truth, we as developers don't know.
We don't know. I, as the one who's making it, don't know.
Yeah, exactly.
It could be tomorrow. I don't know. Maybe CA's going to say, hey, here's all the tools right here. It's actually only like two buttons that you got to press and it's done. We've just been holding out on you.
We also need the custom architecture.
Yeah.
And we need the script and we need the UI, and we need, you know, the units and stuff, and the battle maps.
And
so there's actually more than...
I start immediately sweating.
So there's much more than just the actual map.
Can I just get on like 1,000 by 1,000 tile and just make all of Middle Earth?
Oh, honestly, I was wondering, could that actually work? Like, because I know the AI.
That'd be so laggy.
That would be like a, you'd have to have like a supercomputer.
Well, not necessarily. Yeah,
it's just like a Minecraft world at 10.
Not necessarily big, but could it actually be possible to make, because I know I've heard that the AI gets screwy when you make it too big, but could it be possible to make almost like an open world multiplayer map that's just purely for like the multiplayer?
That would be so cool. It would be like Bannerlord. You have your armies, but instead of just a single army, it's like you have each unit.
Yeah, but of course you can't replenish them.
Oh, that'd be awesome.
We could do it for like just like an Illithan region, probably, if we wanted to make it like enough size of like 3 different cities, and you could mess around with like whatever, like 80 units.
What I'm literally working on right now.
What?
So I'm working on that, like central Athelion, because I can make it huge because it's a land map.
Okay, so is it all working now, or? Wait, no, that doesn't look like it goes out enough, but it does? What? You know what? I'm just gonna... Okay, so now I have to make siege entry. Create.
Yeah, okay. So...
CJI.
Yeah, CJI.
Entry node.
Siege node type, entry node, hint type, node creation.
Single edge type. What do I do with this? Street edge? Wall edge? Area
street
connection
edge? Street edge, I believe.
And then I just have to put this... Right.
Yeah, so you...
Like this?
I think so. You've seen the picture that
why
I sent, right?
Why isn't it yellow? Why aren't
let's
you...
Let's go over the four things again. So entry street note. Boundary distance, what do you have?
What's street bound? Oh, 5.
Okay. Edge type?
What siege edge type is street edge.
Okay, hint type?
Edge creation.
Okay, that's it. Change that to node creation and get rid of whatever you displaced.
How do I do that? Control Z?
So go back to...
Oh, I did it.
Okay, sometimes Control Z works, sometimes it doesn't.
Sometimes controls... No, now this isn't working. Nothing's showing up now when I do node creation. Do I have to click and drag? Oh, yeah. I see. How do I get it to, like, be curved or whatever to fit?
Oh, shit.
Because it's not straight with the edge.
Professionals, guys.
See if I can figure out. I don't know if you can. Just do your best. Because mine's not perfect either, and it worked fine. Just get it as best as you can.
There we go. It's huge, but does that work? It's gargantuan, but it's the best I could do, really. Maybe I can try again. Nope. It's huge, and it's going to stay huge.
Okay, and then you need to select that. And then over in the property editor, once you have it selected, hit add boundary.
Is this it? What did I just do? Okay, is this it?
Alright, go to the property editor and go to the very bottom.
CJI node. Why are there so many CJI nodes?
You probably made a lot.
This is why I shouldn't be doing this.
I believe... If you click on them, it says type entry node.
Oh, yeah.
So you should just get rid of all of them except for the most recent one.
But what if these are like other things?
Are they entry type nodes?
No, they're all entry. They're all entry nodes.
And then do you see your beach landing stuff?
Yeah.
Okay, so everything below your beach landing stuff is made by you, so you can get rid of it.
Okay. Goodbye. All right, now what do I do?
Okay, do you still have the correct box?
Yes, I didn't delete that one.
Okay, select it, and then hit add boundary.
Add boundary.
Make a... If you look at the picture I sent, it's pretty hard to see. It's like a olive color line. You just make a box around your box that you just made. You want to extend it into the water.
My box is also already in the water. My box takes up like a fifth of the map.
I don't know. I don't know if that's going to be a problem or not. I have no idea. So just make a box around that box.
Make a box around the box. I got it.
As long as all of this is inside the go zone, it might be okay.
It's not inside the go zone.
If you select the go zone, you can drag it by the corners to make it larger.
I don't know where my boundary went. There's too many things.
Oh, no. Yeah, I know. It's so hard. You gotta, like, pay attention so hard.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah, make sure you connect it.
Did I? I think I did. Okay, so now I gotta find my go zone?
Yep.
No, why are you still going? Playing, stop. Go zone. And then extend. Go zone. Alright, well, this go zone is going all the way into the middle of the... Wait, no, it's not extending. It's just moving.
Yeah, drag that up there and then go fix the other corner.
Wait, it moves back down here.
Wait, what? Really?
Yeah!
Then just delete it and replace the go zone and do it as a polygon.
Should I make the go zone around the boundary box as well?
Yes.
Okay, so if you can write this down somewhere, try and make all landing zones flat with edges of map. And if you can, like, write this down in maps or something, in the maps channel. Because I think, well, at least if what we're seeing... Well, I don't know if I'm just bad at this, but it seems that it works best when landing zones are flat with the edges of the map. So when they're perpendicular with it. Or parallel with... When they're parallel to the edges of the map.
Yeah.
So that you can just put them down straight. I don't know if you want to, like, write that somewhere for everyone. I'm not doing these again as well. Someone else, you gotta teach everyone. I'm not. Screw that.
Yeah, I definitely think we need to start with super simple beach landings. So I try to make mines are too complicated, and I try to make them simple.
How are yours too complicated?
Including all, like, the decorations and stuff, so the ships are, like, flying through the docks.
Oh, right. I think I did it.
I should have just made him a big beach, so we don't have to worry about it.
I think I did it. Is there anything else I have to do for this one, or is it done now? I should do more stuff. Simply say there's not more to do. I'm just going to pretend that there isn't.
If there is, there's just one thing.
What? What?
I'm trying to figure it out, because I don't know this map. You may not need to do it. Your AI just probably won't work. I'm trying to remember how to
do it. I might end up just sending this to you and having you do it. This is... What is it?
It's a CJI. And you go to Edge Creation on the hint type. And then instead of Street Edge, do Area Connection Edge.
Do you need both the Battle folder and the Battle Tile folder, or just the Battle folder to edit this?
Oh no, does this mean I have to do it?
Yeah, you're doing that. I'm done. I did one. I did part of one.
Dude, I don't even know. I brought, like, one map into TED before that wasn't mine.
Okay, fine. I'll do it myself. I saved it.
You literally just draw the pink line from a box to a box.
What box?
I'll explain. So, back in the maps channel, the picture I sent?
Yeah.
So, you see the pink line that connects from the yellow box to that white box?
Yeah, what's that white box?
That's a street, AI street.
Okay. You
should be able to find, there should be one nearby.
I don't know if I saw any of those.
We might get to skip this. The AI might not work, but the landings should.
Well, if the AI doesn't work.
Well, like, multiplayer would work. I don't know.
Hold on, I'm gonna go get
It's really hard for me to describe you how to do it on someone else's map.
I'm gonna go grab something to munch on. I need munchies.
Stress food?
Yeah, I need stress food. This is stress.
I mean, if it's something fairly simple, I guess we can find a community member who's willing to, you know, do it. I mean, I don't know how complicated this all is.
I mean, I can do it. It would just be easier if Pajito just did it, because it's his map. But I don't know if he's available or not.
Him and me, we're just about to start uni.
Oh, really? So, y'all go to the same one?
No, in England. We'll soon start.
Y'all know each other, like, in person?
No. I know he lives in... Or he goes to uni in London.
Oh, okay.
That's just on the road from me. So he might be busy for a while.
Yeah. So, like, I can do it.
You know that chap who joined recently. What's his name? Caswar?
Caswar.
I mean, it's so cool. Like, he's a guy, you know, who's got loads of free time, and all he's doing is importing buildings into the game, which, you know, for those of you who don't know, was quite a tricky process that we didn't know before. Well, only a few of us knew.
And most people didn't have access to it. That was the real issue. So it was just victimized for, like, months.
Yeah.
And we are modding Total War Attila. Whoever just asked that. Sorry.
Victimize is the guy who's working on the campaign tools, so anything we can do to relieve his workload.
Yeah.
What was the question?
Oh, we're just talking about Caswar joining to do the importing the architecture.
Which is
very important. But I also learned as well, so it's...
Why did I just get a ghost message from a lot of previews? Ghost preview?
There will be no boats clipping through the land. That will never, ever happen.
No.
That's a joke. It's already happening a lot.
Yeah. Even on, like, the one that works currently.
Okay, but in our defense, that's the first time we ever tried a port assault, and it's pretty dang good for first time.
It is! It works!
Alright.
I did hear Ulta saying something about previews. Although I'm not sure.
Oh, about there being ghost pings in it or something?
No, about potential content.
I feel like I got one of those the other day as well, though. Okay, so... Oh, yes, I see it. So I got to draw the line from the yellow to the white? Yellow to white?
Yep.
All right. So what is this line called? Where do I find it?
The CJI? Pink one?
Yeah.
So under CJI, change the edge type to area connection edge, and then hint type to edge creation. Just draw it between the two boxes.
That... What? Perspective? Hello? That doesn't even touch either of them. Yes, wait, but the yellow... The white is inside the yellow? What?
Is that a question for me?
It's a question. Have any of you guys...
Or is that
guys...
a cry for help?
It's a cry for... It is most certainly a cry for help. Have you ever seen that, like, meme where it's, like, Luigi and Mario and, like, they've got a, it's like, one of the lucky boxes. It's, like, stuck in a tree, and, like, he looks at it and he's got, I have a question for God. You know what I'm talking about? No? Yes?
No, I don't know.
No, I don't know.
That one. It's very fitting for me right now.
Oh, yeah.
You know that one?
Yeah.
I have a question. That's how I feel right now. Huh?
Oh, yeah.
It's gonna be okay.
Wait, why is it... Why is it... Wait! Street edge, right? Oh, entry node. I'm learning. You guys are just, I bet those sick bastards are enjoying my pain. The ones watching this.
Yeah, this is not. This is painful for everyone involved.
It is.
It's just a tough process. And how do I break the news to Leo that I think?
What?
I think I skipped something.
What did you skip?
Oh God.
What did you skip?
Maybe you should just send me the map.
What did you skip?
All right, just finish up what you're doing, and if it doesn't work, just send it to me, and I'll take care of it.
What?
There was like, okay, so another box. It's not Street AI, but it looks identical to it, and it's called Area Node. And
yeah,
that has to be in between the Street AI and the Connection Edge. But it might work. It might still work. I don't know.
Oh wait, no, that's because it went over to Philip's channel. Okay. We were having some concerning things earlier where we were getting ads, or I was getting ads on Rise of Mordor videos. I got one ad on.
Yeah,
something.
I got one as well.
Yeah, that's not supposed to happen.
It's always the first one of the playlist.
Yeah, it's always the first one.
That happened to me when I streamed.
It must be that video. But I checked the video and it doesn't have any kind
Maybe it's with the playlist? Because that's definitely, that should not be happening at all.
It's not a copyrighted. Okay, it's not playing an ad for me now.
Yeah. All right. So how do I do this connection thing that you were talking about? Just tell me. Just.
You want me to tell you how to do it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Also, how am I supposed to connect the yellow to the white when it's always at different angles, no matter what angle I look at, because of how it's like underground? How am I supposed to? Does it work so long as it pretty much works, like, from one angle? Or does it have to, like, work from straight down? Is that how I should be working on this?
I'm not sure what you're asking.
Never mind. Alright, so what is this new thing?
Carl Johnson asking, what are the boxes? Is that the question for you?
The boxes are the AI, so, like, when you're fighting in single player, they know where to go, where to defend, and, like, where to hold troops in reserve.
So whenever you hear about, like, a map having bad AI, it's because this section was not
done. Yeah, it's, like,
well.
The hardest section to do.
There's nothing to do with the actual visuals.
Yeah, it's what makes it function.
Like, you could play it with single player, but or with multiplayer, but then whatever. I do really like these little piers here. So what is it that I'm doing here? Oh, right.
Well, he wish I knew more about this to because like I think you're gonna have to delete some of his and redo part of it.
What?
Because you have, like, roads crossing where the landing zone is. And I don't know how. It just looks like a mess. And I don't know what's going to cause it to crash, or if it will at all. So I always just do mine very, like. Like, his are fine until you wanted to include landing. Because see how there's a road AI there?
Yeah, I do.
Like, that's where I'm, like, confused.
Razorback saying with the.
You try it though. See if it works.
Question of, there's wargs, but will there be goat cavalry and deer cavalry?
Hold on,
yeah.
Hold on.
Just
Where was it? Where was that thing Caligula posted?
No, it's the monster.
Where's the thing Caligula posted? Hold on. Oh, can you just bring it? Can you bring it in here for me, Dad? Can you bring me the sandwich? Where is that wonderful picture Caligula posted of the boar calf that he made? You know, that one?
Oh, I saw it this morning.
Where did he post that?
I'm not sure.
I want to show that stream. It's amazing. Is where, do you know where it is? Let me just search goat.
And yeah, Carla is essentially a pathfinding. Everything to do with the AI is through those lines.
Here you go. Here's your goat boar calf. So I'm just gonna hope this works, and if it doesn't, I'll send it to you. But I've got these sections worked out. I think I'm getting the hang of it. Oh God, you know what? I am not doing the yellow stuff for this box out here. This one is just going to not have. You know what? Only players can land here. Only players can. Just I don't know how to fit a yellow box around this. Is my mic working?
Yeah, it's working.
My pain. Yeah, I'm just. You know what? We're gonna try this. Okay. So what's next? Now the stuff that I know how to do. Finally. Thank you. Okay. So let's count. 1, 2. That looks like 3 and 2. What is this white outline around the whole map? What is this?
That's the exclusion zone for trees.
Oh. Oh, so this map's not meant to have trees? Or?
So, do you want me to explain that?
Sure, explain it to stream. It'll be interesting for them.
So what you can do with trees, you can either go into like the selection where you pick all the trees you want and you can manually place them and see them instead. And then you have to do an exclusion zone around it. So most people do it around the whole map and place the trees manually. Or you can do a bit of both or just this one. If you don't do an exclusion zone and then paint with a forest appropriate to your climate. And depending on what opacity you use, how big the trees are, it'll also include stones and like flowers and stuff. So I'm actually trying to get to where I use a bit of both. And that's actually what I'm doing right now.
Oh, you want to? I'm trying to figure out. I was just going to say, you want to show it to everyone, but you're doing the. What are you working on? Oh, Illithan, you said, right?
Yeah, the crossroads into Morgul Vale. So I'm having to do exclusion zones for the dead tree parts, but then the parts that don't have dead trees are still going to be really lush, are going to be the forest brush. And we'll see how it turns out in game.
I cannot seem to click on C. I am failing miserably. I also noticed some of this stuff, like, on 1 gallon. Why is this here? All of this, like, random, weird terrain stuff. Like, what are you guys doing that's causing this?
Wait, what are you talking about?
Over here, you see all this, like, weird terrain stuff right there?
Oh, wait, I gotta switch to Discord.
I like how the heights are all messed up over there?
At the edge of the map?
Yeah, like, on the edges there. Why is that all like that? What did you do to it? How?
I don't think I've ever done anything over there.
Well, I mean, like, on Long Gallon, I saw something like that as well. I had to, like, flatten them.
I don't know. I truly don't really know what you're talking about, so I don't know.
Alright.
Arthur D, hello. And Joss saying, sorry, what base is this? If you mean base game, that's Total War Attila. And Ermin Softic asking, can I play this mod in Grand campaign? Unfortunately not. That's what we're working on right now. We're in the battle tile map so that all the battle maps line up with each other for the campaign. It's very much work in progress, and there's a tool being made that, you know, that allows us to work with the AI. So still lots to go. It's progress is being made.
You know, I kind of understand why Total War games in general have such bad AI. Because, like, whoever, like, set up, this is how we're going to do AI stuff, was a maniac. Like, it's crazy. It's all, like, the hardest parts of everything.
Mm-hmm. Ah, what's the Fortress Siege map? What's this map called?
Enelon, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
Been made by Lil Wutt, also known as Fajito. He's made most of the Gondor maps.
Indeed, this one is in Anfalas, I think.
Mm-hmm.
I think that was mine, Lon Galen. But I don't, maybe this one is too, I don't know.
This is Andrast, which is the westernmost region.
Mm-hmm.
And I think the only fiefdom without a unit representing them.
Why?
Really? There's a fiefdom that doesn't have a unit?
Yeah, Andrast.
Well.
So basically in campaign.
You know what you have to do.
Yeah, well. I've tried adding units to the roster in Maestro. Against it.
Really?
I proposed a tier 3 Los Arnak Axe Shock, but that's...
Oh yeah. I've seen some stuff of that.
But there is one unit coming that I think he doesn't mind.
Is this a secret unit that hasn't been announced?
Oh no, it was a custom bodyguard. It hasn't been announced.
Okay, I think I know what you're talking. I don't know if you've told me or not.
I don't have it up.
Or Boromir's custom bodyguard.
Is that coming now?
It needs to be confirmed, but I don't think he minds it.
Okay, sweet. Yeah, I was a big fan of that.
And of course you have the Ithilien Wardens, which are new.
Oh my god, I know, Mom.
With
what?
Doesn't need to be done anytime soon, so. We just gotta catch Maestro when he's in a good mood.
Yeah.
I think, he's got a big meeting tomorrow.
Yeah, we need to not add more to it.
It's a massive list.
Leo, were you asking what is the White Company?
No, I had my headphones off for a moment, so I was just asking what you guys were talking about.
That would be cool.
I'm always a fan of more units, dude. I can never have enough.
Yeah.
Especially for campaign, like, White Company would be a late game thing, you know?
Yeah.
White Company? Not Grey Company. What's White Company?
It's Faramir's bodyguard after Aragorn becomes king. When he goes to live in Ithilien.
Oh yeah, because he becomes like steward of Ithilien or whatever.
Yeah, so if we can do it where people change bodyguards, then that'd be really cool to have like a professional looking white and gold Ithilien ranger unit.
I really like the idea of like those your standard Gondor armors, but like with different color schemes, like gold and white and black and gold and stuff.
Something I kind of like the idea of is like the tier 3, like of course the fiefdoms all have their own colors.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm wondering if the tier 3 that you recruit from those fiefdoms takes those colors.
Ooh.
Oh, that would be cool.
Yes.
Instead of being silver and black, you're silver and red or silver and green.
That would be so cool.
And it's possible. It's not possible.
No, it is.
It's only possible for different factions.
No.
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Unless you make them all AOR.
Why not?
Aren't they already?
Well, no, you'd have to make the,
That would be such a cool thing.
Well, what you could do is...
What you do is you have a unit and you can actually, you could... As long as you don't modify the model, you can tint it in different colors.
Well, what you could do, actually, is... You'd have to make them each separate unit, so you'd have Gondor, Lothanark Infantry, but you could probably just put that, like, in its tags and just keep it all as the same name. But, so wherever you recruit it from, each of those... Each city, each, like, region, like, it has a special barracks, so, like, you have Lossenark barracks, which I think would already have, so you can recruit fiefdom units. You have Dolamroth barracks, Lossenark barracks, and Fallas barracks, and so when you upgrade those, while it's all the same unit stats, unit card, everything, they have those different visuals, you know what I'm saying? I think that could be done.
Like, that would make me so happy.
Yeah.
We need to keep that in mind.
With AOR recruitment is that it's not settlement specific, it's region specific. So essentially in central Gondor you're going to be able to recruit Blackroot Vale archers, Ringler Vale swordsmen and Lamadan men from all three of those settlements.
Well, what I'm talking
really?
Yeah, we can't make it that you only get Blackroot Vale from the
you
Blackroot
can do
Vale
unique
settlement.
Buildings that are native only to one settlement, and you can just
like, are those three
unit.
Fiefdoms in one province? Is that how it's
yeah,
working?
It's province based.
Wait,
but we're deciding to do that anyway because we want, you know, I think we were discussing it before. We need Gondor to have a tier two.
But why
we
don't
want to make those troops more readily available?
I get that, but at the same time, why not like, just do unique buildings for each of the settlements or whatever. So each one has their unique building that recruits only those specific units. You can only recruit those units there.
I guess, yeah, I mean, that would be the more faithful approach. But I like the idea of having more. Because if you have three settlements that can recruit these three, that's more of my beautiful boys that I designed.
Oh, no, I agree.
Something related. Do y'all think... I don't remember... Is there any cities that we're doing for Gondor that aren't a capital of a fiefdom?
Oh, that's a pepper.
I don't know, but regardless of that, do y'all think we should do each fiefdom capital have its own banners? Like Lon Galen have Hand Floss banners?
Yes.
Because I've designed them. I've got a little...
Okay, good. I'm glad
you... send it in
Cause I think there should be at least a few Gondor cities that... Or a Gondor city, because they could very quickly just have none of those. I don't know.
Well, we could have the Gondor flags in all of them, technically.
Yeah, but yeah, I would like to put Anfalos banners in in Lon Galen, because that's the capital, right? Anfalos.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Although, contrary to their color, which is like an orange, their Lon Galen means green.
Oh really?
So it might even be tactical to put some Pinath Gelin banners as well, which are the green ones.
Yeah, I think we should definitely do that. That'd be really cool.
What do you think, chat? Haha.
I've sent all my fiefdom banners in UI.
Yo, chat. What do you guys think? Yo, community engagement. That's what LG tells us to do. And he's kind of like our boss, sort of. I mean, I guess Hagna is your Jox. Jox doesn't like being called, like, the boss. I know why, but, like, even just more, like, jokingly, he doesn't like it.
Elegy's the big promotion guy.
I mean, he is currently the also the server owner, so.
Oh, Elegy?
Or... Yeah, he's the server owner right now. Because Jox decided to give up some moderation privileges. You think we need a campaign map ASAP? You already said, guys. He needs a campaign map ASAP. Oh my god, dude. Sorry. Let me get that to you right now. I didn't realize you needed it.
If only.
Yeah, you see, I've had this completely working version. I just have it like on my hard drive. I just mess around with it sometimes for fun.
We're just going to wait another year.
Just to keep you guys waiting though. We're going to wait another year.
We've all played it. It's really
yeah, good. We've all played it. It's really fun. So, my favorite faction, honestly, I love what Jox did with them, is, like, the Haradrim, Far-Harad. I just because I love those jungle things. Like, it's like, woo, we're swinging in jungle and stuff, whatnot. Because if you guys didn't know, we've actually decided to add in the jungles of Far-Harad, so we will actually have jungle maps. Which I'm really interested to see what they're going to look like. Like, how we're going to do a jungle city. Like, or whatever. What do you imagine as a jungle city, Mehran?
Ooh, I don't know. I mean, I get sort of Aztec Aztec vibes, you know, with like
that'd be cool.
Pyramids or like, I don't know,
cigarettes and stuff.
Yeah, yeah. I guess that's a job for our concept artist.
Yeah,
are
they seem like a lot of fun.
The concept artist?
I do happen to be a concept artist as well, yeah. But if I'm really busy, for example, I'm sure there's others who have great ideas too. And if, yeah, I'm sure Haganaz will be able to deliver something really cool. But yeah, I'd be happy to try something.
The question about boat fights, it happened at the beginning of the stream. We already got one map working. And we're using the ship sub mod, so if you just want to use that, you can do a naval battle.
Indeed, and we're going to post a naval battle soon, hopefully. Fingers crossed. On the channel, we'll do a live stream.
The software is Ted. You download it from Assembly Kit Tools on Steam.
So, my office is a bit full, but as I say, there's no real lore for Far Harad, so we could really do whatever we want, so long as it
fits.
Yeah,
exactly.
Like, there's nothing we really have to stick with, just so long as it fits.
The only thing we're taking from the films is that they're the guys with Mumakil, so they're the guys you have to subjugate to be able to train Mumakil, and they're taking the aesthetics of that, you know, the guy that rides the Mumakil that Eomer shoots with his spear. That's all we're taking, and the rest is ours to make up. Same with Umbar. The only thing we really have are the corsairs and the ships.
The question about Ornor cities, Amon Sul, I believe, is the watchtower, the Nazgul, Stefrodo. That will probably be just like the movies. The rest, we don't know. It sounds like a lot of fun because we could get really creative with the concepts. And I suggested, depending on when we get there, if the Amazon series comes out, there's a good chance that will show some of Arnor, so we might take inspiration from them.
Very true.
Because that's in 1 year from now, so I don't know where we'll be one year from now.
That may, I mean, because that Arnor is going to be in our third release of the campaign.
Yeah, I feel like Arnor is definitely back.
So that's quite far away. And Joss asking, would Arnor be in it at the beginning, or is it where you have to reunite the three kingdoms? I don't think it'll be the three kingdoms, because they're just sort of gone by that time. It would be a case of just reuniting the scattered remains from all around and reuniting with Gondor to become the reunited kingdom, as the name suggests. Tharbad sounds like a cool one, and Anúminas.
You know, I still don't get how our Erebor video got so many views, our Erebor trailer. I guess it just took off with the algorithm. Actually, the duality of man. I believe that's already the plan, Robin. I don't know where my two compatriots went. Did I unplug?
Sorry, I just got to the loo. Ask it, Robin, you're saying, looking forward to Arthur Dayne and Cardolin units. So no, we're not doing the whole split into three kingdoms thing. Arnor, it starts as Rangers, which is a horde, and then it will become a kingdom which, like Gondor, will have its sort of dedicated main line. The only one of those three is Rudar. There's one Rudar unit available to Gundabad. Like Rudar Hillman or something. But by the time of the War of the Ring, the three kingdoms just weren't a thing. Although something we have been discussing, which is very far in the future, is our alternate timeline campaign.
What?
I haven't heard about this. Fall of Arnor.
I thought you were talking like alternate history where like Gondor falls instead of Arnor.
Oh, no,
which I was about to say. That sounds interesting, actually.
It does sound quite interesting. It'd be kind of weird.
It would be, but it would be interesting.
But yeah, so we're thinking of doing a Fall of Arnor campaign in the future. And of course, at the time of the Fall of Arnor, there was a civil war between the three kingdoms. So you would see the three kingdoms, each with their different aesthetics. As well as, of course, Angmar.
But, you know, we first got to finish War of the Ring.
Indeed, indeed.
I think that's the hardest part, not trying to figure out how to make all this, but trying not to make it all at once.
Yeah.
It's all just so cool.
I want to move to Fall of Arnor. I want to make three Arnors. I've got to make one.
Yeah.
An Arnor is
why make
sweet.
One when you can make three?
Why and make would, one?
When you... I'm over here supposed to be finishing Moria, and I'm just working on the Morgul Vale because I'm just too excited.
Indeed. And you know, Fall of Arnor would mean we can make Angmar. We get a full Angmar.
Oh, yeah. I do really.
What
would
Angmar look like aesthetically?
And we would make a Khazad-dûm
Citadel.
Frusty would go through the. You would be beaming.
I think the Angmar. What's it called? Khazad-dûm? Something like that.
Yeah, Khazad-dûm.
Khazad-dûm? Yeah, I think that would be really cool.
Is Angmar was human?
Maybe they'll be shown in the Amazon show.
Yeah,
was Angmar human or.
I don't know, actually.
I hope it's orc, because there's not a lot of, like, actual orc architecture.
But I'd actually bad humans. Not, like, misguided humans, but just, flat out.
Straight up evil.
They're just bad dudes,
Yeah, that'd be cool.
That would be cool.
They'll come and, slash your tires or whatever.
One owner, yes. But what about second owner?
Oh, love it.
Yeah, so much cool stuff can be done in Eridor.
Yeah.
And I'm kind
of
glad
we're
doing that last, because we have a whole lot of time to think about it, and like I said, the Amazon show can maybe show us something that we haven't thought of.
Yeah, exactly. And Eriador is during the War of the Ring, that's the most boring theater, just because nothing actually happens.
You think it's boring? I think the civil conflict over what tea is the best for breakfast is so entertaining.
Oh, no, you have a point there. You do have a point there. But yeah, I mean, Angmar was orc and men combined. That would be cool. That's kind of something we haven't done before as well.
Oh yeah, so many cool opportunities.
Mm. Oh, love it. I wonder how we'd approach the elves in a Fall of Arnor campaign, because they'd be even stronger.
Yeah, they would
be more numerous than they are. During the War of the Rings, I don't know how we'd balance them out.
Maybe you just don't. Maybe you just do like a
40K don't you let them
thing.
Be what they are.
Yeah. But also, I think what we were thinking about is that in Gondor, we could have the civil war at the same time. The Kinstrife. So you'd see a sort of a conflict in Gondor between.
Gondor gets enough attention.
Well, yeah, but if we were to do a Fall of Arnor campaign and just make Gondor the same as War of the Ring, that's a bit boring. I think we could really. And Gondor would get lots of Mordor's land during the Fall of Arnor campaign.
Oh, would it? Oh, yeah, because it held. What was the Kinstrife? Because I've heard about it so much, but I don't actually know the lore behind it.
The Gondor one, it was... What was his name? Castamir? He was this... he was a guy that rebelled against the king. Because the king was of non-pure Numenorean blood.
Mm.
And he rebelled, and he managed to capture the throne, and he ruled in this tyrannical rule. And then he got he got sent to Umbar. He fled to Umbar when he was conquered again.
Exiled.
Exile, that's the word. Well, I think he fled. He fled with his.
And he founded Umbar, right?
Well, no, that was because Umbar was always a dark Numenorean settlement, or a King's Men settlement. So he fled there.
Isn't there some little island off the coast that is held by the King's Men, really bad boy King's Men or something?
I don't know.
Or maybe that was something from older lore. I don't know.
Well, if you mean Numenor.
I don't know. I don't know what I'm talking about. No, because I know from the Imperador Rome mod or CK3 mod, it had something like that, but I don't know if that was just made up or whatever.
I'm not sure.
Okay, that's done. So now I can process this, hopefully. Woohoo. Bob-Dasimlikit.exe. Then he destroyed Osgiliath.
Oh, and he tried to move the capital of Gondor to Pelagia, I think. And people didn't like that at all.
What am I about?
Mum.
I'm going to say it again. What am I about?
Mum, why?
Because I'm mum.
Why?
Give me a fucking bite. Because I don't want to hold one, but I want a bite.
No! No! Get your own!
I don't want to hold one.
Take it.
I want it.
Here. Why are you like this? Nope.
Did
you buy this? Yes, Mom, I did.
Did not, liar.
You know when you have food and someone says, oh, I don't want any, so you don't get it.
I didn't want any. Asshole.
Please, Mom. Leave me alone. I love you. No, actually, we can't do that, so please don't. And then they decide to just start eating your food. Sorry, I was just being yelled at for mentioning that. You know, someone just came in and decided to start eating my sandwich out of my hand. Just grabbed my sandwich and start eating it, even though they didn't want a whole one, they just wanted mine.
It's always like that.
It is. It's like,
what can you do against such reckless hate?
Yeah. Sorry, guys. It's just... Wait, he destroyed Osgiliath? Oh. Damn, why would you do that? Osgiliath's pretty.
He was a bit of a crazy guy. Oh. Obsessed with pure blood.
You see... Alright, let's actually see. So I see someone says British soap opera. Can you guess... So there's me, Alec, and Mehron here. Or I guess, so Leo, Alec, Tom. Who can guess? Where are each of us from?
Yeah. Stream is now demonetized.
How's it demonetized?
It's from your in-game music. But that shouldn't affect the stream. I think all that means is we can't put ads on it ourselves or gain revenue.
Yeah. We don't do monetization.
Yeah. We stay well away from any kind of financial gain for this.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I just realized that I have this up. Ooh, it's like the three. I just realized that I have that up over there. You know, I absolutely love just looking at the recommended for our team channel, for the Rise of Mordor channel.
Yeah. It's quite a...
All right, let's see. So we got claim your free $50 Bitcoin.
British, and Canadian.
Whoa, there's two British people.
Who is the second British person?
I mean, I'm assuming I'm
me and
one
Leo.
Of them.
There's no way they heard me talk and they thought I was any of those people.
Yeah. I don't know, Canadian American. You can get them mixed up. They're quite similar.
Although I guess
it depends on where you're from.
Where you're from, yeah. Mm. Yeah, because, like, yeah.
Someone likes wrestling and likes to use our, like, the team account to watch wrestling.
Yeah. Sometimes there's such, like, interesting or bizarre stuff, I just start using that one.
Yeah, it's...
It's strange to see a feed that isn't your own.
Yeah, it's shared by everyone.
Yeah.
Like, most of it makes sense, and it's like, alright, I expect this, like... Spider-Man, the dwarves are marched to reclaim Gundabad, epic cinematic legion versus phalanx, 33,000 Romans, battle of the trident by Needham Cam, Fauna's ASMR RRR made everyone ascend.
Yeah, indeed. Oh, we've got some strange suggestions here. One is the States, one is the UK, one is Poland.
Poland?
Or French. Someone is from Eastern Europe, British South African.
I think the three of us are the most, like, English-speaking.
You're making me feel better about myself.
I mean, if you're talking about where you're from, maybe they're talking about where they're from, in which case that's cool.
I think they're talking about where we're all from. It's... Oh, for South African, yeah. Mehran... Is a Brit.
I'm not British South African, no.
Yeah, no, but he's a Brit. He's from the UK.
British, yeah.
And then half Alec Japanese. And I are... Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh.
Very much British. I can't speak
Alec and I are American. Right, you're not Canadian. Yeah, no, you're American. I always...
Me?
Yeah, no. For some reason, I thought you said you were Canadian.
No.
You are quite similar to Canadian accent, I think.
Really?
I don't know, you sound like Mega. Mega's Canadian.
Oh, he is Mega Canadian.
Yeah.
It's hilarious. I'm from Alabama, so...
Really?
I guess I'm deeper south, from deeper in the south than you are. I'm from Texas.
Wait, really?
Yeah, I'm from coastal Texas. I'm from Houston.
Neither of you have the stereotypical accents, though.
Nope, and we are from...
Cool. Yeah, I don't want to be told I sound like from Alabama. I just assume that.
No, I don't want to be told. If anyone ever tells me I sound like I'm from Texas, I'm gonna go start taking voice acting lessons or something.
I guess that's only like the rural accent, isn't it?
Or
like,
mm-hmm.
Is it even a thing today? I don't even know.
It's the hillbilly accent, or whatever, the rural...
The redneck.
Mm-hmm.
And Victor's saying, well, the entire team in general. The entire team is, like, strangely disproportionately European.
Compared to, like, what, American?
Compared to, American or Asian or... I think we only have one... guy, which one of our concept artists is Asian, I think.
Yeah.
And there's only a few of you Americans, Canadians.
Well, I mean, one of the things is with, you gotta be, one of our, like, our really one requirement, I guess, for that with, is that you have to be able to speak English to some degree, or I guess jocks with some of the Russian people on the team. So... I guess that does kind of make sense. People who are in or nearby, whatever, the Anglosphere or whatever it's called.
Hmm. Yeah.
Whereas that doesn't have...
It's just interesting, though.
Yeah.
You know, we've got... But then again, we haven't got that many English people on the team. There's myself, there's Lowatt, there is one of our... So Matt Henley, one of our 2D interns, and Dutchie. That's it. 4 people, I think. Compared to the Italians, there's like 30 Italians on the team.
We have so many Italians.
Yeah. Lots of Dutch as well. Spanish.
Mm-hmm. We have one person who is every Scandinavian country but Norwegian. He's not Norwegian. He can be Swedish, Danish, even like Icelandic or Finnish. I don't think those are counted as Nordic or Scandinavian. I don't know how that stuff works. But he's not Norwegian.
They've all got the cross in their flag.
Yeah. He can be any one of those ones with the cross and the flag, but Norway. Zarn is not Norwegian. He can be anything but Norwegian. He's probably moderating the chat. I don't know if he's on this moderation right here. If he's our moderator for this right now.
Poor Zarn.
Wait, hold on. Let me see if I can get Zarn to join us.
I keep just going back and looking at all these banners. It's so cool.
Mm.
Do we have any... Did the units carry the banners?
I thought we, like, tried that at one point.
Oh, we should do that, definitely, yeah.
Yeah, that's
not
what...
Not at the moment. Some of them have them on their shields and on their...
Oh, yeah, if they have them on the shields, that's not as bad. But for...
Yeah.
I think for units that don't have, like, sigils on their shields, they definitely carry banners.
Mm. Yeah.
Like, we are severely lacking a lot of eyes at the moment.
Yeah. The one thing about banners we have to be cautious of is that, of course, they don't move in the wind.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's why, like, what Bruce has done on Harad is they're more of like an upright banner, as if it's more like cloth stretched to a frame or something.
Mm-hmm.
That feels more normal because, of course, that wouldn't move in
real
life.
Yeah, I think that works fine.
Oh God, I don't. Sorry. That's a pepper.
What are you feasting on?
A sandwich, and I just bit down on a pepper.
Ooh,
I need some food.
Food's good for you.
About to. I'm checking this map in game. Then I'm gonna go eat.
Mm.
So a land battle can be any size, right?
I'm honestly not sure.
That sounds amazing.
Do me well. Try it. See what happens if you do like a 20x20. Just boot up Ted and see.
Well, like, in terms of campaign map, it doesn't matter. As long as, like, I don't care about the deployment zones, and I just want the land to look correct, it doesn't matter, right? That's what Victimus said.
Yeah?
20x20 sounds, like, crazy.
We could test on the map I'm working on right now.
Well, how would you make it 20x20?
If I want to do 20x20, I was thinking more like maybe like 12x12 or something just a bit bigger.
Oh, actually, you're asking me how much room is there. Let me see real quick. I gave you what my estimate was. You could probably squeeze two in there, but you'd have to give them a good squeeze. Like
two 8x8s.
Yeah, you could definitely fit two 8x8s in there.
Between Minas Morgul and Asgiliath?
Yeah.
It will also be 8x8s?
Yes, you could.
Oh, I don't. Are you sure?
Well, so Asgiliath. Hold on, let me find something. Asgiliath is.
Trying to cover everything in between, so it'll just
That's
be like
cool,
the best
man.
Looking site
yeah,
from any of those
that.
Maps.
Well, this right here is Asgiliath.
Oh, yeah, I guess you will actually, yeah.
You could probably actually fit three.
Oh, wow.
Wait, where's Minas Morgul supposed to be? Like,
I don't know.
Here?
Because how far can you see from one map? Because you said you could send.
That's
you said
what
you could see Minas Morgul from Asgiliath, so.
I honestly don't know. I can't tell you. This might not work. I might have messed something up. I think I did, but who knows?
just put it in the game. It actually looks pretty cool.
Oh, what, the new map?
Yeah, just to see, because you know the in-game visuals are far different than Zed. Obviously, still huge work in progress, but check maps in a second. About to send a few screenshots.
So what's the deal with, like, that plateau there?
That's going to be the Morgul Vale.
Hmm. Oh! You could do a bit better with the blending of that white and then to black. It's a bit abrupt right now on that bridge.
Oh, so the white bit is the Gondor side and the black is the Morgul side? Yeah.
So in between the Vale and the roads, there's going to be a mix of Gondor and Mordor rocks.
I feel the gradient or between the two, or the change in rock, would be over a greater distance. Though it might feel a little bit unrealistic.
Yeah,
I don't know.
It could use a bit more of a gradient.
I don't know. We have to just try it out, I guess.
Yeah, I mean,
we should take those.
Yeah.
We should like.
You can see half the map hasn't even been moved.
But it's looking good. Looking really good.
What was I trying to do?
I do really like seeing the Mordor rocks on grass, though.
What do you mean?
This is going to be the only place to have it. Those black volcanic rocks, but still with grass.
Although, I do agree with Hagnaz. Do some, like, gray instead of the white.
Yeah, I almost did that originally, but... I wanted to be clear that this part's, like, still uncorrupted, but I can do that.
Yeah, that's what he's saying is... I'm gonna have to agree with him.
Damn it.
Sorry. Oh god.
About to send in one of the pictures that I'm trying to nail all the stuff in the movies and the artwork.
Oh, what does it look like in the movie?
That bridge, like, in the artwork that I looked at, use that, compare it to the picture I sent. That's what I'm trying to do over there.
You're not doing good enough. I'm sorry. For those of you who are still sticking around through all of our insanity, you're the best. You're cool.
Indeed. I'm just redoing the thumbnail, Leo.
Huh?
I'm just redoing the thumbnail.
Oh, for Edders? Yeah, we had a good number of people at the start of the stream when I was energetic.
Did you do Edders in the end?
Yeah, I did.
Okay, nice.
That's the one that I did while you were gone.
Ah, sweet. And the Ross. Yeah, getting the custom architecture. I swear I've done an Edoras thumbnail already. I'll do another one.
I feel like you have. But it may have been for something different.
Maybe.
Like, so it wouldn't say campaign mapping outside, whatever, whatever. Oh, because I think we did a Siege of Edoras. Edoras or Edoras?
Edoras, I don't know. The R.
You have to roll the R.
Edoras.
Edoras. Well, no, it's meant to be Anglo-Saxon, right?
Yeah, I don't know. I'm not good on the pronunciations.
Well,
but I know
but
that Tolkien always spoke with these massive rolled R's.
Oh, did he?
Yeah. When pronouncing his names.
Like Gondor.
Gondor.
Well, now that's just like that.
I've only heard him speak like one time.
I don't know if I've ever heard him speak, like any recording of him.
Mm-hmm. How cool was it that they built a whole Edoras on that hill?
Did they? Or...
Yeah. The whole thing is, including the hall, they just built the whole thing on that rock.
I didn't realize that. You know, I don't know if I'm gonna do the final thing. Ooh, our not Norwegian boy is gonna join us so that we can make fun of him for a bit.
You sound a bit quiet, by the way, Leo.
Oh,
I don't know
hello,
if that's
hello,
just
hello,
in the
hello, hello, hello. Is this working now? Hello. Is this better?
I've just turned up your volume.
Oh.
I don't know if that's.
All right. Yeah, our not Norwegian boy is gonna join us so that we can make fun of him for a bit. And call him anything but Norwegian. And by that I mean, I asked Zorn to join us because he's always the life of the party. I don't know. You know, I wonder. I haven't checked it in a while. Remember what our analytics used to be, like with the gender disparity?
Oh yeah.
I wonder.
I suspect it's very similar.
So for those of you who don't know, much to our dismay, in the past, we had, I don't exactly remember, let's see if it's still the same. I'm going to pull up the analytics while this thing loads. We're up to 0.3%. That's higher than it used
really?
To be. That is higher than it used to be.
That's much harder than it used to be. It used to be zero.
Yeah, it used to be 0% female viewership.
Let's go.
Woo! Now we have to figure out who's getting all of the viewership. If it's like just all Alex or something.
Mm-hmm.
Lifetime.
Hello there.
Oh, hello.
Hello.
Hey, how are you doing?
Did you
I'm
know,
doing well.
Last 28 days, yo, oh, lifetime viewership, we're actually up to a whole 1% female.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. We're up to a whole 1%. You can actually see it on the bar chart,
what?
On the chart.
Why do you join the industry we talk about female viewers?
Because...
Oh yeah, if people don't realize who I am Sound 13,
he's
nub on the Discord server.
Yeah, no, he's our not Norwegian moderator.
Ah, yes, I am Finnish. Perkele.
I need to go eat something, I'll be back in 10.
Okay.
Bye, man.
See
ya. See
ya. I'm honestly surprised that we have 1.1% female viewership. So what does that mean? We're approaching a million views, right? Where do I look for that?
Oh, I was just looking. Yeah, we're on 980,000 views. Yeah.
So what's that then? Like we've got. We have 10,000 views. No, 1,000.
We're under 12,000 views left to a million. Yeah.
Wait. What's 1% of a million?
That 1% of a million is 10,000, I think.
10,000 female views?
I think that's right.
Not bad. Sorry guys. It's a continuation of something. What in the world's going on there? Okay. No, Edoras. Rest in pieces. Oh, wait, what? Oh, hold on, guys. Oh, see? You can see Greece. I was just trying to figure out what's wrong, and then I realized, oh, I'm using the wrong height map. This is interesting. My vision's gone white. What's happened? I descended. Sorry, guys. the sound is pretty bad. Like, are we quiet? Is what quiet?
I think you're still quite quiet, Leah.
Why am I quiet?
I've just got you turned
hello,
up.
Hello, hello, hello. Oh. Well, let me try something. It's these new headphones. They're better quality than my old ones.
There we go. There we go.
Oh, is this better? Oh, how much better is this?
I thought it was me.
What?
Has it gone quiet again?
Hello, hello? Hello?
Yeah, there we go.
Hello, how's this?
It's going lots of white noise.
I'm not hearing white. I don't.
Hang on, let me listen to the playback of the stream.
Oh, no, the white noise you're probably hearing is my fan, actually. Because I have a pretty loud fan in here.
Oh, I just
was imagining it came from me, to be honest.
Oh, did you was that? Wait, is that going on? Right there, white noise?
Oh, I said that. I don't know, but it could potentially come from me.
Wait, is there really bad white noise right now? Or has it been fixed? Someone talk to me. I don't know what is going on.
Yeah, it's probably your fan. I just unsubscribed from the YouTube channel.
Really? Because of how loud my fan is?
Yeah.
Oh my god. Everyone point and laugh at Mayor On or something.
But yeah, there has been a load of new faces here. And if you would like to find out more, you've got social media links in the description and our Discord pinned in the chat if you'd like to join.
Is the Discord
is where we do everything.
Is the Discord in? What is the name of the Rise of Mordor mod? Someone just asked that on the Discord. If that's someone in the
What is the name of?
What is the name of the Rise of Mordor mod?
Yeah. What?
Oh, yeah, it's an actual question. Oh.
It is. I actually do get what the question is. I'm just still
I know what they mean. I know what they mean. I think they probably mean what's it about?
What's it?
Yeah, I get what that means.
But what's the name of the mod, dude? What's the name of Rise of Mordor?
I don't know. I've worked on it for over a year now. I don't know what the mod's called.
No clue. I bet. I don't know if Jox knows. He's only worked on it for like 5 years.
Yeah.
6 years? 6 years. More than 6 years. There's Attila came out in 2015.
It used to be called the Lord of the Rings mod for Rome 2 when it was originally for Rome 2.
Really?
That's
a great name.
The genius
name. We should rename it to the Lord of the Rings mod for Total War Attila.
Yeah.
the creativity is it's blooming.
What brand what's brand recognition? Oh, no, Edoras no work. Okay. But it seems. Oh, God. Why? Woo! Anilond worked. Sweet. Oh, now I have to remember how to do this trap. Okay. So you guys, so those who have been with us, you guys can see, here's Anilond, which we had placed down on the map. And like, if I come up the coast here, wow, look, here's Longgallen. Wow, wowzers. I'm sorry. That was dreadful. Okay. Total War Wiki, because that's where they have all of the different heights that I need nicely written out. Have you ever checked out the Total War Wiki? Because for whatever reason, they actually have a section on the Total War Attila Terry, and it's so helpful.
Mm.
It's like the only bit of stuff that CA has ever provided
but it's honestly helpful. Now where in the goddamn world is that? Okay, yay. Yippee-ki-yay. Question, does anyone have any questions as to what I'm doing? What tool? Damn it. Okay.
I see.
Render doc. There we go. Oh, I always forget what render doc is.
Try my best to answer it.
Whoa, look. Streamception.
My room.
Yeah?
Also are here.
Yo, Streamception. I'm gonna do Streamception, cause I'm here. I'm just trying to get this to work so that I can actually test to see if that AI that crap that Alec and I fumbled with for a while actually works. But I'm losing my will to do anything. Zarn, we were talking earlier. Of the people on the team, so how many do we have any people from like outside the Atlantic, like outside Europe, America?
From what I've seen, most people are from Europe.
Yeah. Chris is from Asia, I think.
We have two testers from America, you, and then we have Crapjack.
Yeah. Mega's
so
Canadian.
Four people. Casual is also Canadian.
Yeah. Megan Casual as well.
So, there's a fair bit, but you can definitely see this very Europe-centric group. When it comes to like where people come from,
we were trying to figure out why that is. Like, why is it Europe mainly?
Why is it Europe? That's a good
why Europe.
Question.
It's more of a thing of because we know that 25% of the members of our Discord are from America, and I think 12% are English, and then it gets somewhat smaller and smaller. But why is 25% of our mod team not from America? Our development team.
Well, to be honest,
because we're lazy.
But if you really look at it, we have a big group that is from North America, I should say, but they just seem to be less active than the European counterpart, I guess. So I guess that's why. You get that. Unless we're going to talk about the people who make submods. Because then I think you will see a lot higher number in Americans doing stuff.
Why would you say that?
Looking at it now, it says US is 24% of our server members. England is 11, or Great Britain is 11. France is up next with 7%. And Germany, 7%. And then Spain, 4. Netherlands, 4.
I would have thought Russia would be higher.
Russia and Australia, they're 3. I thought Russia would be higher, yeah.
Yeah, I thought Russia would be like number 3 or number 4.
Make a accurate prediction when it will be out, and we are also making custom tools to also be able to do this. So if we literally just can't give an accurate statement, but we are hoping 1 to 2 years, but it's only hopes. It does not mean that we'll actually manage.
It's our hopes and dreams
to do it by that time or etc.
Indeed, indeed. There's more than just a visual map, as we were saying earlier.
Yeah, the faction roster, scripts, and etc.
Battle map, scripts, UI, concept art, all of that stuff.
Oh, the loading screens.
The loading screens are awesome.
It's strange to think that for some of our concept artists, that's all they're going to have in-game. They're going to have a few loading screens, but that's everything.
Nothing wrong with that.
You can always just say, I designed that unit. I didn't make it, I designed it.
Of course. It's strange.
This is cool to see this little mountain here. Inventory. I'm putting an Anilond. I'm bedding it in right now. It's quite a nice city. I think all of our maps are quite nice. So. Quite nice. So Mehran, what are you working on? I hear you clicking away furiously at something.
That's me typing.
I don't know. I think my microphone's too quiet to pick up my clicking.
Oh.
I seriously think it's just me typing.
What are you typing?
I just did the thumbnail. Okay. I redid the thumbnail. For I put that in promotion.
I'm uploading a replay of a Rise of Mordor battle I did earlier today. Imagine that. I actually play the game.
What? You play the game outside of like the few sparse like dev clash like things we do for stuff that we don't trust the testers with?
What?
Wow.
Wow. Yeah.
It's, no, we... It's... You really don't like the testers.
Wow.
You didn't hear what I said. Did you hear what I said?
Yeah, I heard what you said, but it's clearly intended as a joke. And,
yeah.
You shouldn't take it too serious, people are watching. But if you have more questions to ask, feel free to ask it. I'll try my best to answer it. So, yeah.
You did. Did you hear like what was going on a while back with like jocks and them or whatnot? Do you remember that?
No, best to not talk about any internal conflict.
Internal, I mean personal drama.
Drama.
Haha. Ha. I don't know. Call it whatever you want to, but it's not the thing that would be needed to be taken up, I suppose. So
yeah.
I don't see it. It's like if I had a bad customer service with a cashier, I don't have to say it publicly.
You're not a Karen?
You know, oh my god.
Yeah. If you have bad customer service, you are like obliged to tell everyone so they know not to go there. Duh.
You know what I realized?
You have to start filming as well.
Yeah.
I don't think like American restaurants would like me very much because I would never give tips.
No.
I would never do that. It's like, if I remember correctly, it's like an expectancy that you do.
Yes.
It.
Well,
so that's how they get money. That's how you. That's
yeah.
So most of waiters' wages come from tips here.
Yeah, I would never tip.
I'd give a tip if there's good service.
So do you guys only give tips, like, if the service is very good? Because here it's just, if the service is very good, we'll give a big tip. But otherwise, it's just...
Why would you give a tip if they don't serve you well?
That's the funny thing, because, like, in Europe, it's like, oh, you give it if they did, like, an excellent job. In America, it's just an expected...
Yeah, like, if you don't tip, they don't make money. That's how they live.
If you give extra, it's just implying, oh, they did well. Which is interesting, like, cultural thing.
Yeah. It's you get judged based on it's, like... Do you get... I almost wonder if it... if it results in... I know it's a horrible, horrible thing, but it's a very bad practice. But I wonder almost if it ends up resulting in better service because, like, the waiters are like, oh, I'm not going to get as much money. I'm not going to get paid very well this week if I don't put my heart into service, to the service.
Well, sometimes restaurants sort of, they do a tip pool. So actually, if waiters get the tips, they have to put it in a jar and it gets divided up at the end, which I don't think is fair. I think that if you are a good waiter, you should get to keep the tips.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, I guess so. But I just wouldn't tip because, well, I'm not rich, that's one thing. Call me a cheapskate, but that's one thing too. I don't know, I don't really know how much you would like normally tip a person for things.
I think it's...
Unless,
what's the expected tip? It's like 4%? I don't know.
I don't know,
It's a bit...
I would only... I'd give them like... £3, maybe?
That's
$3.
Like
What is quid? Because I always hear you guys say quid, but I thought you guys had pounds and euros.
Yeah, it's pounds, the same thing.
Using quids. Cringe. We used the krone.
Same thing.
No, the krone is a lot more weaker than the pound or the quid.
The quid and the pound are the same thing.
Yeah, I know, they're the same thing, but, you know, one sounds cold and all the other sounds British.
Oh,
yeah.
I thought quid was like,
oh, hey,
would equal
okay.
up to a pound or something. I don't
yeah,
know.
Like that's like cents or pennies.
Yeah,
or
yeah, I thought it was like cents.
No, so we have pence. So 100 pence is a pound.
Mm.
Yes, then what's a quid?
A quid is a pound as well, so it's like the slang.
It's just like another word for
dollars
it.
And bucks, I guess.
Okay. I learned something today. That's cool.
Oh well. I feel I wouldn't tip at the place unless I go there often and I have like somewhat liking X person or like I don't know, the service person. Because I have some restaurants I go to and there's like oh, this is gonna sound very simp, but there's like a young girl there. I don't know. This sounds bad.
It does. Young girl.
I say young girl, but she's probably like 18. But she just seems nervous, and she seems to be new to like the workspace. I've seen her doing some mistakes, so I don't know. Perhaps it's just out of pity, but. In that scenario, I feel like I would probably tip because I go there.
Well, do you not
like
tip
because
her,
I like
where
the
you
pizza?
Are?
No, I don't. I have never tipped in my life.
Oh, you're saying so even in America, like where it is customary, that's the only place
I would not even in America. If I go to America, I literally take like the buy the social credits or whatever. I'll take that and not tip. I'll just be like, oh.
So honestly,
all right, here's $70.
I actually don't know, like, because there is nothing making you tip. You could just not tip.
There's nothing legally saying that I can't. The only thing is that just people look at you and be like,
really,
wow,
dude?
You're such a cheapskate. I can't believe
it
that.
It depends how much you care about other people, what other people think of you.
No, it depends on how much you care about other people.
Well,
if Zahn doesn't care about other people...
I'm intrigued.
You're thinking like that.
You pay for the food. You pay for the food, and that comes to, let's say, like you say, $70. Where does that money go?
Not to the waiters.
It doesn't go to the waiters. That's strange.
It goes to fresh food and the maintenance of the kitchen.
No, it doesn't. It goes to the owners.
Yeah, but they spend it on that.
No, they don't. They keep it for themselves.
How the hell they manage to get food?
Well, no, of course
place.
They don't get. Well, I mean, like some of it goes to the chefs, some of it goes to like the managers.
So you're not technically employed by the...
No, you are, you are. Some of it goes to the employees,
oh, right.
But not enough to be a living wage.
Gotcha, okay.
Okay, it's just a shit wage.
Yes, but so it's like below minimum or whatever, I'm not sure. It's horrible, it's... I don't know.
But the thing is, it's not that I'm sitting there like, oh yeah, I would not tip because I don't give a shit about this rate. It's just that I'm like, well, I'm broke as shit. I mean, if I was earning a lot of money, yeah, sure, then I would tip. But I never tip because I'm just poor.
But like,
that's it.
But like, even if you're just going to a restaurant, and you, like, and you just don't tip, like, even if you're going back, like, what's going to happen? They're not going to go out of their way to be nice to you? Are they going to ask you not to come back because you didn't tip?
No.
Well, in Europe?
No, I mean, like, here, I'm just wondering.
Oh,
they ain't going to do shit unless you come back, because then they're going to be like, oh, it's that
thing that could ever do
again.
Is spit in your food.
Yeah.
They could
does
spit in your food.
Does it look like I give a shit? I probably have too strong immunity.
Nothing
probably
requires
like,
you to
Yeah, it's disgusting, but the thing is that you're unaware of it. If someone were to, you would never realize it. Unless it's like, I don't know, gum or something.
I guess, yeah. I just realized that I've been doing all of this work off stream. I've been doing it on my other window.
We still managed to retain 35 people.
You guys are
interested in tipping opinions.
Tipping opinions and looking at Leo's still screen.
Yeah, sorry guys. I'm good at this. We're professional.
We are professionals, yeah.
That's a joke we tell ourselves.
Joke?
I mean, that's the truth.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
Exactly.
I love how Mega has We Are Professionals as part of his 3D scene.
What do you mean?
Yeah, I love it.
Wait, what are you talking about?
He models everything.
When he's modeling, he has We Are Professionals in the background.
Wait, no, now I need to see this. What? I don't watch enough of other people's streams.
Wow.
Where's his latest one? Morgul Raiders? Or was that Fruitsy?
So, Leo, could you tell me what you're actually doing?
I am adding... That is good. I should add that somewhere. So what I'm doing is I'm adding Anelond as a port assault on the map, like Longallen or whatever else. Green. The color of blood. Red, green, blood of an angry man. You know, LG and I once, like, we sang that song, like, through text messages, like, we'd each send just, like, one line at each other for, like, a day, and it was... It was good. That was fun. All right, let's see if this worked. Woohoo! Total War Attila.
Total War Attila.
Total War Attila. What else? What other game you think I was gonna do? Like Warhammer?
Imagine that. You're legally making a mod for Warhammer.
Imagine immediately making a mod for it. I'm almost done.
It's 2 minutes. Around 10 more minutes. Yeah, I'll finish.
Tell everybody goodnight.
Should have joined earlier, shouldn't I?
What do you mean, watch your hand?
Have you guys answered a lot of questions that I've gone through the chat, or have you just been busy?
I'm actually almost done. Like, as I was honestly saying, it would be completely done in 10 minutes.
We answered some earlier.
No one's
asked questions for a while.
We actually had, like, consistently, like, 100 viewers earlier for, like, a good, like, 20, 30 minutes. It was quite nice.
Seems like I just broke it. The instant I came here, it dropped, like, with 40 people.
Oh, no. That was when I started fumbling around with stuff trying to figure out how to get things to work.
Because
we had to redo stuff on both Edoras and Anolond that didn't work for tile maps. And since I don't know how to do that, Alec had to walk me through every single step of what to do. Which isn't that good for viewership retention.
Yeah. Alright, yeah, I think I realized why I would tip at that restaurant.
Why?
It's because she reminds me of me. A very incompetent young person trying to just starting their work for first time in life. That's probably why I won't tip, because I'm seeing just a person who's just starting in the working life, and I'm like, oh yeah, I feel you. And you fucked up just like me on your first day of work.
Yeah, just like me, baby.
I think it's because I have grown up in like a... I haven't really grown up in like a, oh, you can just toss away money kind of environment, so that's why I don't...
I mean, I haven't either, but it's like, if you don't tip, what are you doing, man?
Yeah, but that's the cultural thing there.
Yeah, no, I guess so.
Like, in Europe, it's a lot less, like, required thing, because you won't be looked down socially. If you're, like, in Greece or something, you don't have to tip.
But you should to help their economy. Sorry.
What? Oh my god.
God damn it.
Well,
that's like the only thing I know about like European like politics sort of. Is Greece bad economy? Sorry, anyone from Greece in the chat.
There's other things, but I would probably tip out the Greece restaurant. It's because generally if you find like a good one, they're pretty nice.
Yeah.
And it's very ironic because you have like, you go have like two restaurants within like, I don't know, 10 meters or some shit. The one is shit, the other one, the street over, is like fantastic. They make great food, they have great people, they're nice. They're like, oh yeah, recognize you. How
in
you
Italy,
doing?
There's so many amazing restaurants when I was in Rome. Like these sort of.
So, it's slightly not working because I need to redo the no-go. So we won't be able to take a look at the port section of this, but we can take a bit of a look at Anolon.
Oh, we've had some people in the chat.
Yeah.
What?
Michael Bolin saying, this stream has been great alongside some Baldur's Gate 3. Hype for the campaign. Oh, thanks, man.
Baldur's Gate 3. You're cultured, man.
Cultured.
Martin saying, I wish I had a set of skills to participate in this amazing project, but I sadly don't. Well, the answer to that is you can absolutely learn.
Yo,
I think.
Mehran.
You know, yeah.
Sorry. So, so Alec Hagnaz and I were talking about this last night, and now it's time for you guys to go. Favorite pizza? You just get a first pizza that you're gonna say. For me, it's spinach, onions, and just cheese, mozzarella stuff. Hagnaz was goat cheese and honey. Alex is, what is yours?
Barbecue chicken.
Yeah, so what is it for you guys?
Oh, mine is kind of cursed. But
what is it?
Myron, you can tell first, because I have like the most junk
you're
food.
You're gonna hate mine. My favorite is a margarita.
Oh, okay.
I'm actually not familiar with the margarita. No, that's the white sauce one, right?
Margarita is just nothing.
Nothing?
Oh, wait.
Do you mean...
Just cheese?
I just eat the bread.
Cheese.
Yeah, just, I mean, that's fine. A lot of people like just
cheese. It's nice and simple. If I had meat, I would say I do like chicken on a pizza.
So you don't like tomato sauce on yours?
Oh, yeah, it has tomato and cheese. Tomato and mozzarella are the staples.
Oh, wait, but why are you saying... So margarita's just the plain pizza, just your normal...
That's
your margarita's a different... Is actually... I don't know how to describe
it's the
but
white
it's
sauce
just,
one,
it's
right?
not plain. No, that's Alfredo.
What's margarita?
Margarita is just mozzarella.
It's got like this special kind of like thick cheese or something, I think.
I don't think so. I mean,
here at least, like it's not.
I didn't do the height map. Okay, that makes sense. I forgot to do the height map, so that's why I forgot to process the height map. Hence, this is still being here. But you guys can see, we're a bit outside the city, but it seems to have worked to a degree. It's interesting to see it because it's a bit high right now. It doesn't have the water, because as I said, I forgot to export the height map changes I did. But yeah, and I think now that we have this in, I am gonna start to wrap up the stream for the night, because I have some things that I gotta do. So thank you all for watching. Wait, hold on. No, I was hoping I could like walk over this bridge with this unit, but no, it's right out of bounds. What happens if I do this? But yeah, with these guys climbing this cliff as physics allows. Yeah, thank you all for watching.
Physics-based game.
Thank you all for watching. I hope to see you guys again soon with another stream. Please leave a like and subscribe if you haven't already.
Check out the social media.
Yep.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
See ya.
See ya.